Hey y'all, it's Aaron from the Underground Railroad. You are tuning in to another great show on the 4Eyed Radio Network. To listen to more of this show and other great shows, tune into www.4eyedradio.com.
That's right, kids. This is your good pal, Steve-O, from 4Eyed Radio Network. I'm here to talk about a great person. Now, think about it. Who are you going to call when your logo looks like shit? You want a kick-ass logo. You want people to see your logo and go, you know what? That's an awesome logo. I wonder who did that logo. Well, I'll tell you who could do your logos for you. Check out Raven Designs. Special care of your work. Special inquiries? Check her out. She's got everything. RavenCruise.com is the place to go because you want a kick-ass logo. You want to stand above the rest. I guarantee it. You hear this song in the background? You know these guys have a kick-ass logo. It's a recognizable logo. And I guarantee it, if Raven was back in that time period, she probably would have made it for them. And they would have been like, hells yeah, people know who we are because we got Raven Designs behind us. Check out RavenCruise.com if you want a kick-ass logo for business cards. Maybe you want to put it on a car. These guys did. Maybe you want to put it on your building. You want something kick-ass. You want something that people can see and just go, this is awesome. Check out RavenCruise.com. And you know what? Do it. Do it right now. You got nothing else going on for you right now. Get a kick-ass logo. Check out her artwork, RavenCruise.com.
Howdy, rowdy. Welcome back to the Underground Railroad.
Yeah.
That was not Elvis, but it was
supposed to be
my
jailhouse rocking.
My apologies. I typed in just jailhouse rock and then
you're fired.
Was that like a cover band
really?
Of Elvis?
Yeah.
It was?
Really? Yeah. You're going to fire me? And then you heard me about doing live show. Okay, fine. You
well, the whole thing was that Natalie just got out of prison.
I am back from Camp Kill Yourself. I made it.
Did you cut a bitch? Tell me you did.
I cut some parts with a bitch.
There you go.
No, it's really funny. Actually, we call farts doorknobs.
Really?
In the joint.
That's the way you beat
that's how. Back? That's how you warn people. You're like, oh, I'm about to doorknob.
Wow.
And everyone like backs up or gets closer depending on
what they're.
Yeah. I'm like, you doorknobbing? Dang, it stinks in here. You doorknobbed. But yeah, it was pretty. I learned some lingo.
Did you cook any burritos in the sunshine?
No.
You didn't defrost any in the dryer.
They come back with a beautiful tan, though.
Did you go Lesbo? That's the elf in the room. Did you go Lesbo? Did you?
She's already
you had
been
to.
There.
You needed it.
You got your cut
there
on.
Was plenty of Lesboism, so I didn't need to add any more.
Really?
Yeah,
okay.
I think it would have been over the top.
Oh.
But it exploded.
Yeah, I think the whole place would have just been like twat waffles everywhere. Just raining
twat waffles galore.
Yeah. So
It's raining twat.
Everyone would have been full, it was crazy because like they would feed us in the morning, peanut butter and jellies, and it was really funny too because the brand name of the jelly on the jelly packet that they gave us was Lucky
Jelly,
and Lucky Jelly, and I'm like, lucky if it is jelly and not just like.
Bird blood,
or broken,
delicious,
broken dreams.
Or maybe they meant to
we're
buy.
We're feeding you your broken dreams.
Or maybe they meant to buy. You're lucky. You're getting jelly.
Yeah,
you're getting fed.
Bitch. Or it's like lucky, and you're like, oh yeah, I'm lucky. I'm feeling real lucky right now, being in the fucking tents. But at dinner time they would serve slop, basically what they would call rat skin.
What?
Yeah, it was so gnar. It was so gnar. And like,
I would never order that on the menu. Never.
The ants wouldn't go near it. The flies wouldn't even land on it. The birds.
How'd it taste?
The birds would like fly the other way. Basically like wet cardboard.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was disgusting.
Do they still give you donuts with your dinner?
Yeah. Right.
No, it was like, it wasn't like a real donut, but they like, it was like the weird mushy stuff, the rat skin, I guess.
It was definitely weird mushy stuff.
And then there was like a roll, and then there was like another little brick of something that apparently was supposed to be something.
I don't know. It looked like it might have been good the first time, but
yeah,
this time around, it was, I mean, and it's like they would feed us the same thing the next day, and it was like almost as if it was from like yesterday.
Yeah,
that
probably.
They were leftovers from yesterday that they just like slopped onto a terrible thing. Oh, it was bad. But
you look good though. You look cut up. Like you lost weight.
I didn't lose. I gained weight because all you do is just eat peanut butter and jellies and sleep.
I'm just trying to say nice things.
What keep
would
going.
They do? What would they do if someone was
you look
allergic
hot, you little prisoner.
Yeah, what if somebody had a nut allergy? You just don't put the peanut butter on your bread?
Yeah.
So you don't get any protein. You just get bread and jelly.
You just get bread and jelly.
I would die if I went to prison?
Or
to jail? Or to
Sheriff Joe's,
the Sheriff Joe's Resort?
The minimal security jails, the county. Yeah, no, it was... It was great. It was good. I got a lot of reading in. I finished two books when I was in there. Ciao. The Gunslinger.
Yeah.
Stephen King. And it was really funny, too, because, like, when I was being let out for work release, some guy was like, hey, what book are you reading? I'm like, I'm scared of you. Don't talk to me. I'm like, Stephen King Gunslinger. Like, all mean, like
I'm
don't
tough.
Mess,
don't
with,
mess
me.
With me.
I know what to do with a gun.
Or a book.
Or a book. Yes, exactly. This is and it could be a weapon. The thing was a fatty. But the guy's like, dude, I'm reading that too. And
no
I'm
way.
Like, shut up.
And then you guys made out.
And then he's my new jail boyfriend.
No way. That's so hot.
More than one jail boyfriend.
I had two.
So hot.
I had two jail
boyfriends. You're living your life. I love the way you're living your life.
Thank you.
I'm proud of you. My parents, however, would think differently. But
yeah, parents.
You know, you can't please them.
Hey, I'm proud of you. And that's really all that matters.
Thank you.
Hard to impress.
Yeah, some girl made
Wait,
me.
Wait, is that true?
Made me a tampon.
Wait, I'm sorry. How does one make?
Was it soap?
Basically,
was it
tissue or was
it
cotton?
It was cottony tissuey thing, and like what they used. What they used as for the string.
Yeah,
the grenade string. Or whatever. they.
I've never called it a grenade string.
No, I know exactly what you mean.
That from here on out.
But they basically used the elastic from like their underwear and like the sports bra. That because some of them are given like the pink sports bras.
Yeah.
And like
Wait,
the whole
so if
outfit.
You're, if you're on your period while you're there, they don't give you anything.
There's pads everywhere.
Like, yeah, because I think it might be something you can get at like commissary.
I used a bunch for like. I put them in my towel, rolled them up in my towel, and that was my pillow.
This sounds like a human rights violation. That's what I'm hearing.
Dude, I mean, if I had a nosebleed, I would have been good.
Are you worried now that you've used one of these incredibly unsanitary tampons?
I didn't use it.
Okay.
She was like, terrible because I had a UTI going in.
Yeah.
Oh.
And like at one point,
you asshole!
Wow, what was funny about that?
Nothing,
Norman.
No
just
idea.
Us girls having fun. Can you continue?
Please start rubbing your breasts now. There you go.
Yeah, you need to check yourself for lumps. You know, you might.
Shit. Yeah, you want to fist bump your titty and say,
"Fuck!"
Keep
I
it
just
classy.
Felt a lump. I'm not kidding you guys.
Oh.
Men get breast cancer.
Oh, that's
too.
A bone.
I think
that's
I might have
a
lump
that's
on my ass.
Bone.
Will you rub it for me? But no, Jesus.
Yes.
It was intense. Like the pigeon started looking good to eat. Like
oh,
I
yeah.
thought about like catching one. And like,
I'm actually kind of glad you clarified that because before I was like, the pigeon was looking really good to fuck.
Oh,
and I was like, wait, what?
That too, you know.
Bestiality is awesome, right?
See, and Natalie just. She lurks on the plains of prison. There it is, the pigeon.
Oh.
Unaware in the bush.
Oh, get it? Get it?
Nice.
National Geographic.
National
Geographic. I thought you were doing like Shawshank Redemption.
She pounces.
Natalie had a cross.
I just heard you say that was in the bush.
I made a pet rat.
That works really well.
No, it was terrible because the pet crematory.
Yeah.
That sounds
good. There's a pet crematory in prison?
Nearby, right?
Yeah, it's like fucking too close. But at night, you would just smell like burning flesh and hair. And it was so bad. And that was just from the heat.
Oh, gross.
Of my skin burning.
But,
really? Yeah, it wasn't from the pet crematory.
It wasn't from the pets, but it was just Natalie's.
Natalie's
stank.
I smelled this awful smell and then realized it was me.
I'm the smelly thing.
I am a smelly monster. But yeah.
It was just all that rat skin seeping out of your pores.
Jesus Christ.
We need to go on like a detox for you now.
I need to. I really do.
Get this girl some veggie and fruits.
I felt like I kind of went on a detox when I was there because all I would drink was water. I ate a shit boat of oranges. Yeah. Which actually, you guys.
I thought you actually ate a shit boat. <No water. laughs>
Yes.
Oh, God.
It was like a little, it was served in a little gravy boat. No, but.
We had that conversation where you were like, I'll take other people's shit and put it inside.
So you get oranges.
Totally. So, but oranges. I had this massive sore throat while I was in there. Like, I couldn't eat. It felt like when I swallowed, there was a pineapple lodged in my throat. It was intense. And like, I went to the nurse or like one of the guards, and I'm like, I need to see a nurse. My glands are like bigger than my face right now, and this isn't normal.
And
they're like, well, if we take you to the nurse, you're gonna have to go to Australia jail, and they might not even let you out. Like, they might not let you come back, so you might have to stay in Australia. And
until you're better, or just forever?
Until you're better. I hope not forever. But
ooh, but shit, then you wouldn't get like released for work and everything.
Yeah, exactly. So she and I'm like, all right, I will just turn right back around and pretend like we never had this conversation. So I just ate like a shit ton of
just
oranges,
vitamin C,
and it fucking was gone the next day.
Vitamin C.
I ate three oranges.
Okay, were there tons of oranges to be had? There was slop, and then there was a lot of oranges.
There's just a crate full of oranges.
Okay, I was just
with them. I was playing like soccer with the oranges. I was doing
football. Football.
Thank you, Mr. World Cup official aficionado.
I'm not till another 4 years. We're good.
I know, right?
Yeah.
It's a thing.
But it was good times. Everybody should got my hair did.
Yeah, it looks pretty.
Everyone
sweet.
Should go to jail.
It got
it's
sweet.
Great.
She got sweet braids done.
The cornholes or the
cornrows? Yeah, the corn, whatever.
They're so white.
Oh
my God. Sweet braids.
Those are cornholes. Oh, cornholes, that white person
game.
Yeah.
The
Hicks
game.
The Hicks game.
And cornholes, man. It's like.
Barbecued roadkill.
We go to Sheriff Joe's resort and play cornholes. What up, mister?
Oh, man.
Play cornholes.
Well, I'm glad you survived it. And
yeah, I didn't get raped. Well, except by the prison
that
guard.
That sucks.
So, like, so every time
did you actually get raped?
Yes, I did. Whenever you leave and you come back, you know, to you know, from work release or whatever, they have
to do a cavity.
They have to search you. But there's some DOs. Detention officers for those that
look at you with the link.
Y'all who don't know.
Roll up. But so
okay, now you're the white person at the table.
Oh my God, you just got whiter.
So I'm pretty sure one of the DOs like lost her watch inside of me. I'm pretty sure. So if you guys need to know what time it is, just ask my ass.
Her ovaries are like tick, tick, tick.
Yeah.
Tick, tick, tick.
I literally now have a biological clock inside of me.
People are going to think she has a bomb in her. And she's like, oh, no. Someone just was.
No, I got
someone was cornholing me.
I got searched at prison.
You know, they were investigating my plot
level. And they stop you and they're like, we're going to do a cavity search. And you're like, please.
Again?
The thing that you think is
out?
A bomb, if you could
it's
take that out.
Yeah.
We need to return it to Officer
So
Beverly.
Beverly, of course, Beverly.
No, it was more like a Rhonda.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was. Oh. She was not gentle at all. But some of them, like, or I mean, she was definitely
she
gay.
Cared. She cared.
She's
though.
Definitely
she cared.
Yeah. She cared.
She was like, I'm practicing.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. She
spread your legs. Oh my God, that makes me really, really uncomfortable.
It was intense. It was intense. Like she grabbed my boob and like shook them around.
Guys didn't do it, right? It was just female.
Yeah. It has to be the same sex to do that.
Which is interesting because obviously there's lesbian guards, and so that's almost just like having a guy do it, but. I think
Would your boobs have to be shaken?
Because you could be hiding something in your bra.
Stirred.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
They would make me take my hair down every night.
Yeah, because they're checking
there could be
for
needles
shit
in there.
Yeah,
and it would piss me off so hard because like my hair would be so awesomely braided down and up and just sexy, and then they'd be like
with cornrows.
Oh my God, dookie braids. Cornhole. That's
so,
what we call
so
them.
So fucking hot, man! I love this little prisoner in front
He's
of me.
He's so turned
I love
on
her.
Right now.
I can't even talk.
Mark. Do you watch like Orange is the New Black? Is that like your thing?
No, I've never seen that.
I've watched the first season.
Totally your thing.
I don't have Netflix. I
want to
see it. I want to
crazy
see
eyes.
Good.
My hair was all done, and everyone's like, "Did you? Is you really just got jail hair, don't you?" And he's like, "They're like, the next time you come back to work, there's gonna be a little tear tattoo
on your."
I'm like. Watch it.
You should see what's on my ass.
I'll get my bitch. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, she did get a tattoo on with the trans stamp, but it just says exit only.
Yeah.
What
just
the
in
fuck?
Case.
This guy.
God,
sorry about that.
Are you grabbing your nipples? Are you scared?
No, it was just like such a roadblock comment. It's like a boom out of nowhere. I just went hard left. Suck it, bitch.
But no.
Suck it.
Something happened.
Sorry.
Oh, there we go. That's
much
better.
Better.
Okay, I'm sick of talking about Natalie's prison.
No, you're not. So anyway,
yeah,
then
you.
What do you
we're
have now?
A new story.
You know, right? It's so boring.
But yeah, welcome back.
Welcome.
I
was
thank
not
you.
A good substitute for you, just so you know.
No, I don't believe
I
that.
Tried.
She sucked.
It
was terrible.
No, I was good in my own
hell.
Way, but I was not. I
yeah, tell
I,
yourself
I was
that.
A poor man's Natalie. I was a poor man's Natalie. And
thank
it was
you.
Natalie was
I
a poor
man's
she doesn't
man.
Weigh enough. That's what it is. She doesn't weigh enough. She'll never be a linebacker in the NFL.
My personality
weighs
what
we all what we all want her to be.
Yeah. I was a linebacker.
I'm not you. No. I'm okay with myself.
Yes.
I am not.
We missed you.
Yeah,
I missed you guys, actually.
Mm-hmm.
It was really, especially this one.
Okay, listen, I want to ask one question. We have this little segment, which I never have anything because I'm never embarrassed. What's the most embarrassing thing that happened to you in the joint?
I mean, other than having someone lose their watch inside of your vagina.
Yeah, yeah. Other than that, don't use that one.
Speaking of vagina, so
wait,
basically
wait.
When
you... Can you say
you
that your biological waffle? Clock is now ticking?
Yes, yes.
Did you? She said that.
Oh, did she?
Yeah, she made a biological
joke. She made that
joke.
You're so
not paying attention, producer Steve.
Where are you right now?
Well,
not
you know what? I was too busy promoting your guys' shit as usual. And you know what? It was just a callback, so fuck you guys.
But yeah, basically, they had us, like 15 of us, in so this is when we were being released, and there was like 15 of us in a holding cell. So 15 fucking angsty bitches.
How small was the cell?
Shoebox size.
You wanted to cut a bitch. I know you did. I'm looking in your eyes and I see it to be true. Continue.
What I did was cut up the sleeping pill and snort it that I snuck into jail.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, get it, girl.
Fuck yeah. Totally like snuck in the sleeping pills in my underwear every night. No, like they. Depending,
they're looking for someone that you're gonna stick someone with.
I call it the prison pocket,
the prison,
AKA
pocket.
Your vagina.
But they went in there.
No, I was being silly.
Yes.
But
there was a hand motion that went along with that.
Somehow she missed it.
I'm sorry, I need to invest in a webcam just for this podcast.
I'm starting
to think now.
But no, so like
that's a really good idea.
These
get my finger out of my ear.
No, I will not get my finger out of your ear.
You need my wet
banana in
you need my penis straw to stick in her ear. The wet willy.
You bring that fucking thing near me.
Penis straw.
You're gonna get whipped with that straw. You're gonna get dick whipped.
Man.
It's a little straw.
But
I'm gonna dick whip you with a straw.
So I had
it's a penis straw. very small.
It's basically, for anyone that's in Radio Land, it's a straw with a penis on the
and
end.
Two and two weirdly shaped balls dangling from it.
And you went willy people with it.
It's basically the...
It's a literal wet willy.
It's the bachelorette party straws.
Yeah.
The true definition of a wet willy.
And you know what? And Natalie was absolutely insulted that it hadn't been the first time that someone had stuck one of those in my ear.
I was pissed.
I live my life, man.
No, I don't care.
I know.
Lie to me.
You're my
all
first.
Woman
you're
tell
my
me
first. You're the only one I ever loved. You're the only. You are so fucking beautiful. Oh my god!
Natalie,
there we go. You're doing
with
it.
The dick straw that you have, you can lie to other women with that because technically you have a dick. So
yeah, exactly. I use condoms to masturbate with.
Hot.
I don't know where that was going.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Anywho.
So basically,
what was your embarrassing story?
So basically, I was like telling everybody in the joke because we started playing spades, and I was playing with like these two like rough tough bitches. Like they've been in there. Like she's been in and out of jail for, of course. They've been in and out like since she was 15. She was 30. She's 30 now. Like
she's been doing this for 15 years.
Yeah.
She just can't. What
was she last in for?
She's just a hard door.
Hey,
a doorknob with a big massive fart.
She is a doorknob.
She's been doing
she
the
was
same
doorknobbing
thing for
15 too.
Years, so she's got a career. So.
Yeah, she knows what she's doing. But anyway,
what was she in for this last round? Do you know?
Well, she's a felon. So I think she had like a warrant out, and like she actually got tackled. She was running from the police and got tackled by them. And she had a meth pipe on her.
Oh, nice.
And crushed it in the crushed it in the cop car with her toes and like brushed it under the seat.
Fuck yeah.
Trigger suck.
Yeah.
No, but that's
it was pretty smart. She knows what she's
bitch,
doing.
Yeah.
But anyway, so I ended up giving her a
sleeping pill
from my underwear.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm like,
she loved you. You were in.
Yeah. I'm like,
friends in the joint.
So we are lovers now. And,
yeah.
You had a cuddle buddy. That's cute.
Yeah.
That was protection.
That was my, because I had to like, in front of everybody, just like reach down into my prison pocket.
Yeah.
And get her a drug. Yeah, she's like, it was so funny. She's like, oh my gosh, my tongue is numb. I'm like, oh, sorry.
You took care of your bitch.
Your tongue is numb. You're like, yeah, I still just have
a
gram of cocaine in here, too.
And UTI. So
Oh, I didn't even think. But you, like, stuck it in that lining,
uh-huh.
right? Yeah.
Yeah.
That
exactly.
Pocket.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But still, I mean, it kind of
you know,
y'all got imaginations.
We're gonna just leave it.
I was about to make a comment, and I just said no.
Yeah,
no, do it.
So
what about y'all? Like, what did I miss? Tell me some awkward stories.
Well, okay. First off, we've brought this up multiple times since you've been gone. We need an update on the koi.
Yeah, the koi pond.
I know. I've been trying to get in touch with her, and she hasn't responded.
We
I don't
really
know.
Want to
I know.
Know.
I want to know.
Did Nikki pop out her baby yet?
No, it's going to be in a week or two.
Okay.
Yeah, 2 weeks probably.
So you can be like, Nikki, congratulations on the baby. What the fuck happened with your friend and the koi?
She doesn't. She didn't know about that.
Oh.
She never.
That was a drunk
that
box.
That was for Natalie's ears.
That was a special like bonding moment.
Natalie's ears
driving
only. And we shared it with the entire
world?
Podcast
well,
land.
All 1,000 people that listen to us.
Yeah. I love you.
We shared it with the podcast land.
Multiple
times.
It's
a pretty big
awesome. Yeah. No, I mean,
because they're like, oh, we need to follow up on that. I wish we knew.
No,
what was going
I know.
On.
I'm
we
still
are horrible journalists.
Eh, what up?
I know. I'm
an excellent journalist.
I feel like maybe I haven't heard from her because the owner might have killed her.
That's
oh my god!
True.
Wait.
What was her name?
Jail.
We should look up.
Or she could be
you
in jail.
You guys could be better friends now.
I can give her some hints and some
give her some inside tips.
Yeah,
get her some friends
lingo.
On the inside.
Yeah.
You've grown. I see this. I look at you and go, wow, you're
so
blossoming.
I look fat.
You're
is that what you're saying? Is that
god.
Your way of telling me I look fat?
I was trying to sugarcoat
Thank
it like
you.
It was like an internal thing, but
you
it's
can't, you can't
sometimes. I ate 5 peanut butter and jellies in one day. What?
It's like, how can you gain weight going into the slop zone, though? It seems so unappealing as a food.
Well, so you don't
when you're hungry.
But yeah, but not to like, gain weight. You wouldn't understand. You
wouldn't. You shut your face.
Because of your genetic disposition.
Forget you.
You're 98 pounds for the rest of your life. Accept it. Yeah, she Silence. Does.
I'm like, I take you. Shits that are 98 pounds.
Oh, that's right. I saw one before the show started.
Yeah, that's why I wouldn't go through. I did flush it.
Did they teach you that?
No, you
did
conserving you water. You flush in jail. Otherwise, you might get flushed.
We're conserving water out here in the desert. We got our first rainstorm.
Yeah. See what was in that bowl. You don't want to conserve that.
Okay, I used to live with this woman.
Oh, I'm sorry.
True stories.
Yeah. But... You know, we both had a it's we both had ours to share.
Swamp monster.
Yeah.
But
is that your nickname?
that's what we called
at
what
least anything that came out of you was better than anything that could come out of your brother.
Whoa.
Porcelain Punisher.
Dude, the porcelain punisher.
Dude, yeah.
Like, the paint would melt.
Yeah, the paint was like literally peeling off of our bathroom running. Walls yeah. after like Tim would come out of there.
Oh my god, that poor toilet. Oh, that poor thing.
I need to really invest in a toilet sound for that, I guess, now when you mention
a flushing sound.
Yeah.
Or a screaming toilet sound.
Help me! I'm choking!
It was bad, but... We're gonna.
That worked.
We're gonna find out about the koi's, guys. I hope.
Yeah. This
please,
is,
please do.
And when we do, we'll
I might even
we'll
hire a PI on this
we'll
one.
We'll title the episode.
I just need
don't
to
be
know.
Koi with
yeah.
me.
Don't be coy. Don't play coy.
Yeah. Don't play with
me. Aaron, you have a couple fun, embarrassing, awkward stories from this last week.
Mostly this morning.
Damn.
That was in the morning.
I know.
I got one after you.
The morning
mornings
after.
Are rough for me. So I do this thing in the summer where I like go to bed really late because it's finally nice out.
Oh, no. Yeah, I do that.
We're in the desert. It's finally nice out. And so you stay up late. So at around like 3-something in the morning, I'm finally going to bed. And then at like 5:15, I am awoken by fucking velociraptors in the apartment next to me.
You mean your apartment that burned?
The burned down apartment that I used to live in. And
did you hear someone be like, shoot her! Shooter!
Oh man, I don't even know what I heard at that point.
That.
It was just it was
a little concerned.
Can
for
you? Yeah, okay.
Steven.
But yeah, so crazy sledgehammers, jack noises, jackhammers. Sledgehammers are jacking off and they're you know, getting all crazy up in there, bandsaws, everything, just so many noises. I'm hearing
bandsaws.
Yeah, I'm hearing
the power tools on the construction site. The bandsaws with it. No one's.
I thought
get
that was like a mix between like a banjo and a saw.
All of a sudden, it's like Iron and Wine and Asian Milk Hotel. The next door.
Practically.
Oh,
it was
nice.
it was crazy. It was nuts. I wish it was Neutral Milk Hotel was playing next door because that would have been a lot more pleasant to wake up to.
Neutral Milk Apartment.
It was
Milk
crazy.
Is on fire!
And
in fuego.
The worst part though was I got to a point where like I could actually like start dozing back off to sleep until the man that was like 3 feet away from my bedroom window up on like one of those crane lift things. He likes to whistle while he works and that's great except for it.
Fucking Mary Poppins
it was
over here.
5 in the fucking morning and he yodeled terribly. I love a good yodel. Okay. I really, a good yodel. But there is no room for bad yodeling at 5 in the fucking morning.
No.
And then he was singing that Santana song,
no!
and I can't get it
Why?
Out of my fucking head.
That's the worst.
Como va, or como hoy va.
Como
he just kept singing it and whistling it, and I was just like, oh my god! Like I almost like opened up my window and threw my fucking
this
dog at him. I was
no,
just,
not crazy.
But no, I mean I wouldn't have thrown her at him,
well,
but I mean,
might,
it was like the
like,
nearest
able to, like,
thing.
got his jugular.
And just, yeah, and then I could have been like, property management never notified me that this construction was happening at this hour. I thought somebody was trying to break in.
Like our old landlord who decided
would just show
to,
up,
steal our tree.
Oh, my God.
At 5 in the morning.
I would say, though, if it happens again, you should storm over there in your sleepwear, crazy-ass hair, take your dog with you and just shake your dog at them and be like, shut up!
You need the zombie mask.
Silencio!
Yeah, what happened to that?
Zombie mask coming very handy.
Wait, you have a zombie mask?
We had. I don't know where it went. I think Ryan Nelson made off with it.
Bitch. That bastard.
Hanging out in Nevada somewhere.
Fucker.
But no, Nevada? It was just like, I think.
Ryan Nelson!
But yeah, it was just like. The fact that, like, I actually was able to, like, lull myself to sleep with, like, the jackhammers and shit going on next door. And then it was like, that's great that you want to sing while you work. That's really awesome. Could you just not do it 2 feet away from my fucking bed?
Yeah, and then
at 5 a.m., like.
And then Heidi from Mount Edna comes and starts yodeling.
Oh, my God. And it was the worst yodel. Like, the worst.
Maybe he was choking.
A parakeet dying.
Aww. Yeah.
Like, it was bad.
That's a horrible sound. Parakeets are sad when they're dying.
Okay, I got one.
It was bad.
Yeah.
You have a bad yodel for me?
No, I got a most embarrassing moment.
Do it.
You actually have one?
Just fucking do it.
Okay.
Just fucking do it.
Oh my God. Can you let me express myself?
Just do it.
Because I'm about to express myself.
Do it.
Okay.
Do it.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Okay, so I took 3 Airbnb.
Wait,
and I decided, I go, you know, I'm on the couch, I'm going to jack off.
Yeah.
And then I fucking realize I'm in a mall. A cop tackles me, and I start reciting, some song I wrote
this
like 10
lie.
Years ago.
This is a dream.
Hey, I'm talking.
This
shut your
fantasy.
Skinny 98-pound ass up. Back off, Chipotle.
If you mention
back off.
Wait one more time, I'm going to punch you in the
yeah, face. But I'm going to like
you
it.
Back
so
off,
I win.
Chipotle.
I win every time.
I'm not Mexican.
And then.
I'm not even fake Mexican.
But.
Be like.
But.
I'm Middle Eastern.
Back off kebab or I don't. Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah.
I'll be your lamb.
I got a good lawyer. It's cool. I will not be in that
when
situation.
When did this happen?
That is the end of the story.
I don't believe you. I need more details.
I call shenanigans. Yeah.
What, mom?
No.
What are you wearing?
I've already been like scarred by the Mexican over here. I don't even think I can podcast.
I'm the only person of minority status here.
I can't work under these conditions.
Actually,
in 10 years, white people are going to be the minorities in Arizona.
There's three
shut
of us at the table.
No, you won't.
True story.
No, you won't.
Four white people and one brown.
No, I mean three because there's three women.
Oh, so I'm a double minority?
You are a double minority.
Yeah.
Wait, I hate to break it
I'm
to you.
I'm gay, so then I'm a triple minority.
I'm possibly asexual.
Triple threat.
So, you
we're
know,
right there, babe.
Yeah.
Holy balls. Three minorities.
Yeah.
So I'm on the floor, tackled by three cops.
Wait,
and it's like, I'm in a mall.
Yeah, now
they're oh, I can see. When you, oh, God. None
I'm
of
listening.
You.
I'm
you don't work for me, and it's
I'm
like,
listening.
I don't work for you, and we're cool. I gotta go.
I just want to say, I didn't use any racial comments.
That same thing happened to me, though. That's weird.
I like how you start bringing up race into this when it's called the Underground Railroad.
Yeah.
Well, that's why you bring race into
the
it.
The fucking Mexican got all uppity, so I had to say something.
He keeps calling me Mexican,
but
I'm not.
Whatever.
At least
people,
I was born
whatever
in
you people
at
are.
At least he didn't call you a piñata, like what I do. The Mexican dishwasher at my work.
Goddamn Mexicans stole my Sunday paper off my lawn.
He calls me Raida.
For the last time, cops stop calling me piñata.
Yeah.
You what guys. Does he call you?
You guys, really.
He calls me Huera.
Huera.
You guys, really. We can't be.
Which is white girl.
No. Mm. There's too many white people at this table for this many racist
jokes.
Eric is like the biggest
I
racist.
I wouldn't call it racism. I would just be calling it's it colored.
Color dyslexia?
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
What?
No, it's
well, that's currently
here's
what
the,
Mark
has. If you
want to
say that I'm
going to
blow up
I have racial dyslexia. I do
not. You want to mention Persian rugs? I'm there. Let's do that. But
you
I'm not.
You goddamn camel jockey.
Like, but I do
please.
Not know anything about tortillas.
So if you mention.
We were more into Arabian horses.
If you mention 300, she'll get offended.
Really?
Oh, yeah, that is.
Actually, that was pretty epic. They were pretty spot on with that.
No, yeah.
Are you a Spartan?
I was there.
She's a fucking Spartan.
I'm not, no, she was honey, I'm Persian. Jesus.
Oh, my God.
Well, there's only 300 of them.
Are you still Ambien?
What? God damn it. I'm not going to get raped on Ambien again.
No, no.
You can't make me. You can't make me do this.
Can't rape the willing.
You're not the boss of now, me. None of you are the boss of me.
No, Mark.
Come on now, Mark. You know I have my ways.
300.
Okay, give me 3 Ambien. Let's see if we can do this right this time.
I'm so confused.
Oh, fully charged.
Mark, what I was getting at, it was 300 Spartans and they were fighting the Persians. That's the movie.
300 Ambien?
Is that what
just
it takes
say yes,
for someone
just to... Just say yes.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah, absolutely, Mark.
Come fly with me. Let's fly. Let's fly
let's
away.
Let's fly away.
I love that we got rain and it's all over...
Your face.
Commence all the haboob stories and photographs.
So, Mark, you grew up out here in the Valley of the Sun, right?
I never knew what a haboob was till 3 years ago.
Haboobies!
No, my question
is... Oh, the haboobies!
Do you remember how epic monsoons used to be?
Don't get caught.
They used to not be.
You do not want a motorboat.
They used to be fucking storms, rain and flooding and winds and not just mud.
I think that can happen again with this climate change thing.
Yeah,
I'm waiting for some really big thing.
There is a tropical storm coming through.
Right in Arizona. Yeah.
Okay. Well, no, but we'll get like a fallout from it, hopefully.
I know there's a tropical storm that's going to be hitting the Carolinas.
Yeah, there's a hurricane coming.
Would you like
that's
some
coming.
Ice with your
Arthur.
But not in
Iceberg, dead
this
ahead.
Is the iceberg that
Titanic. Keep your drinks cold, the Titanic.
I'm
going to end
me.
We need to start videotaping
I think
it would be a lot more entertaining for our listeners if they could actually watch.
Natalie is drinking the iceberg.
It's
the iceberg.
I might have
she invented it in prison. Me. She invented it in prison.
This is the thing, though. If I
she's just happy to have ice again.
If you guys do,
she's just really excited.
Cooler oranges.
If you guys do a live video feed, I might actually start making you guys live.
Yeah,
like Thursday nights.
You really should.
It's not like you're editing this shit anyway.
Let's just do it.
We
just power through this.
No, I edited all of it.
You do?
Oh, good. My mom
apparently
just sent me a text. She said she made
I don't listen to anything.
Oh, good.
I listen to my own shows anywhere.
Dude, I saw this
I don't
woman
to my music.
Yesterday getting off of a bus stop downtown, and I thought it was your mom for a second, and I was going to, holler at her and be like, Debbie, what the fuck happened to your foot?
Because
she was, limping with a cane. And I was like, it looked so much like your mom from, the distance.
Crazy.
But then when I got...
Your mama...
But when I got closer to her, I realized it was not your mother at all, and this woman was really upset at the fact that I was yelling at her from my car window, asking what happened.
That's funny. No, my mom, she's lovely.
I miss your parents. She need to get your dad back on this show, and he can talk about that book he wrote.
Yeah, no, he's writing another one. He's just, on a book writing frenzy.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it is pretty awesome.
Does he need someone to edit? Because I can totally do that.
Yeah.
I'm actually really good at that.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, and even, suggestions as far as, maybe you should...
No, I'm...
Fluff this up a bit.
I'm really, yeah. really, really,
don't
really
try
good
to make
at
her
editing.
A fluffer, okay?
I just
but Sarah's a really good fluffer. She's helped me on set multiple times.
Baby.
Best
I can't hear everybody now.
Yeah.
Because Mark just popped away.
I want to know the rest of that. We
butchered that bottle of vodka.
Yeah. All the vodka's gone. Why? Wow. Why is all
there's
the vodka gone?
There's a hole in the bottle, I think.
I feel like, what's his name from that pirate movie?
Johnny Depp.
Yeah.
Why is all the rum gone?
I would be okay with
the rum.
That was a good impression.
We know Steve's good at this shit.
No, I never heard him do Johnny.
Johnny.
Good old Johnny. Here's Johnny.
Sammy.
So, 4th of July is tomorrow. We celebrate
America.
So I have a question, guys.
We might not have fireworks given the storm that's going on outside.
Does England have 4th of July?
No, they cry.
God,
no.
Yeah.
Are you kidding me with this?
Stupids. Of course they
have
the 4th of July on the calendar.
It
was a trick question.
We keep calling it 4th of July instead of
Independence
Day.
Yeah. But the 4th of July is tomorrow.
Oh, my God.
Which means my electricity bill is due.
Yay.
So,
birthday tomorrow. Happy birthday, Dad.
Happy birthday, Dad.
Happy birthday. July 4th is my father. 77 years young.
Hey, that's how old my dad is. Happy birthday, Papa Norman.
I love birthdays because I always sit there and I'm like, oh, my God, like, it's your life day. You were able to survive the elements for another 365 days. Because you really think about it.
You shut out.
The world is trying, the elements, Mother Nature is constantly trying to kill you all the time.
I feel like it's the other way around. We're trying to kill it.
I think
it's a battle.
This isn't 1642.
But then it's going to win in the end.
Oh, it's totally
going to win. The more we kill
Mother Nature, coming to the new land.
The more that we kill Mother Nature,
the more she'll fight back.
Well, no. The more likely it is that we're all going to die.
Yeah.
Bangladesh will be underwater in 20 years.
The bee party.
Building a...
don't even get me started on
the bees.
Without the
bees, we don't have foods. We need the bees.
We got to get rid of Monsanto. That is a good start.
Monsucco. Yeah,
get
no.
Out. Get
Dude,
out.
You know... Okay, sorry. No,
how
I'm
do
not,
we do it?
I'm going to stop because I was about to go on a political rant.
Let's
we don't do that
let's
on here, right?
Make, let's build gardens, guys.
Mm. Okay,
my
really,
God.
Really awesome story.
You garden
awesome
building
story.
Gnome.
In Chicago, check you. This out. In Chicago, they are selling plots of land for gardening for $1 a plot. But the only thing is that you have to live in the neighborhood that your plot is in. So there's they're actually doing this.
They
thing
have
now.
That in California,
so,
too.
Shut up. That's yes. Oh, my God. I thought it was the best
When you think
thing
about
ever.
It, the first grocery stores didn't come about until, the late 40s.
Farmers markets all the way.
Farmers markets.
All the food prior to that was just being grown by.
Have you guys been to the Tuck Shop?
Mm-mm.
It's a restaurant.
Is that for
no,
drag
stop.
Queens?
Nope.
Okay.
It's a restaurant. It's actually really fancy and very, very small, but they have their own garden in the backyard. So seasonally, all their plates come out and they have seasonal.
Oh, a lot of places
yeah,
see that. Even the parlor that. Was like that.
Yeah?
Yeah, the parlor yeah. And also the Windsor.
The
I mean,
Windsor,
a lot of the locally, because a lot of those
St.
restaurants
Francis
downtown.
Is big on that too.
Yeah.
Oh my God, the Pig and Pickle. Has anyone been to the Pig
no.
and Pickle? It's right off no. of, I think it's like
been to the
Thomas.
The Pig or something.
The Pig and
Pickle. Slippery Pig, that's where we get our bikes fixed.
No, the Pig and Pickle.
The Pig and Pickle.
The Pig and Pickle is, I'm doing a little promo here. It's right off of, I'm pretty sure it's off of, it's either McKellops and Scottsdale Road or Thomas and Scottsdale Road.
Oh, that's why I've never heard of it.
It's right there on the corner, and all of their meat is locally bought. So it's they'll get a really epic pork one week or a really epic lamb. And so all of their.
So I decided not to eat meat anymore. I'm just going to eat bugs.
That's
yes.
a good idea.
Jesus, Natalie, can we go make
I
out behind the dumpster?
I was just talking about delicious food.
That actually
yeah.
sounds
behind
really
the dumpster.
No, it's awesome. Every week
bugs
their menu
really
changes based
bugs
on the locally
the
bought
I know.
Meat that they've
Dude.
That they've
so,
got.
So, Natalie,
it's
when are we
so
moving to South
amazing.
America
oh
and just living in the rainforest?
Thank well, you.
If I can ever get a girl to go out on a date with me.
Mealworms all the way.
This is an incredible
you know
cross
try
the
just
park, guys.
Why they call them mealworms.
I don't have friends.
That's the problem.
Meals.
It's easier to make girlfriends
meals.
After you have friends.
Yeah, you should probably have friends
yeah.
first. Baby steps.
Meal
yeah. Baby steps.
Well, I can't even make friends, so.
Everyone
you
goes
made friends with your right hand, I'll tell you that much.
No one at the table says, I'm your friend. Everyone just goes quiet.
Yeah, we're
going right.
I was just
so
in the middle
sorry.
Of
I was way too busy.
A beverage.
Whatever.
Thinking about myself. Way
Dude,
too
the
busy.
New Sin City looks awesome.
And to
yes.
be honest, Steve doesn't have a choice if I get to be his friend or not because we're related, so he's stuck with me.
No,
regardless.
No, see, I have a brother, and we are not friends.
Yeah.
We're barely family.
Whoa.
Yeah, but
are you still on brother?
Dynamics.
Is it a step, or is it a half thing, or a step
brother.
Thing?
Speaking of family 100%, dynamics,
4 years older than me.
Ryan
we don't
called
talk.
Me.
We'll talk about that later.
Okay.
It's really sad.
So you don't have to be friends.
He and I were
family.
On the phone.
Did you get along with your parents?
My mom was a crazy bitch, but now we're okay.
Well, that's moms
okay.
for you anyway. That's
yeah,
okay. that's the definition
that's
of mom.
That's usually par for
the
course. I judge
we're
a girl.
We're sort of okay. Last week, she decided to tell me that all the bad things that are happening to me in my life are because I decided to have sex with someone that I loved, so I took on that person's sin. Let's talk about religion. No, thank you. No.
Okay.
Yay, Sarah's mom.
You got Sarah's mom. But she makes beautiful babies, so I'll give her that.
Yeah. And
my siblings are adorable.
You want to know what I think?
So.
That's a new one.
I judge a girl by how she gets along with her family.
Me too.
Absolutely, 100%.
Also,
it's a valid judgment.
It's the cards that you're dealt.
I've seen that.
I know it's the cards you're dealt. It could go that way, that way, this way, that way.
There was.
I have a
point. It is a valid thing whether you're going to get along with that girl, whether she can get along with her family.
You are spot on, Mark. I think this is the most brilliant thing I think I've ever heard you say.
The thing is, though, is that
you don't. I just talk about nothing.
Other family members,
I
know,
constantly.
You have a good relationship.
I mean, mind you, can we have like an exclusive like sub category for those of us who have really really fucked up family backgrounds?
No, this is a general rule.
No,
I'm not gonna let you get on your soapbox and diss your mom.
Well, the only thing I've—it's
not a soapbox.
I've only thing I've heard
it's
like
I still call her on a weekly basis. I visit my siblings. Her husband died like 3 years ago. We're family, so I'm there. But that doesn't mean that I 100% have.
I'm gonna
to like
put
her.
You. I have a therapy thing for you.
Well,
We're gonna go out. We're gonna go to a nice Catholic church, and we're gonna bring our rosary beads.
Nice.
And then we're gonna walk Catholic. Up to a nun, and we're gonna punch her in the throat. That's our therapy.
Stop that,
no.
I don't know what to say anymore.
See, you started on
dumb.
You started off
I was
strong.
So fucking dumb.
You started off strong, and then you
never talk about hurting nuns. They're like wonderful.
I know. I'm like punching nuns in the throat. Ugh.
Why would you do that?
I know.
Punching them with love.
I was wrong. I didn't know.
Plus, the Pope is like super cool right now.
The new Pope's pretty rad.
He's so I love that.
Does he smoke weed and do mushrooms?
You don't know, but he might. I mean,
he does.
Dude, then he wouldn't be a Pope. He snuck out, dressed in regular clothes, and told people he was like a normal person and went out and started feeding the homeless. He snuck out without security.
Bitchin'.
They caught him. Bitchin'. Well, they found out. He was trying to do it anonymously.
Bitchin'.
The dude's fucking awesome. I don't even, I'm not even pro-Catholic or anything, but the guy is awesome.
Just but do you think that he purposely had it leaked that he went so he could get caught and then it'd be all like everywhere?
That dude's doing whatever he wants the whole time. He's never done anything
The thing is, like, it was sort of like a controversy because he's not supposed to do things like that without,
which is retarded.
Well, but not without protection.
There was a Pope mobile back in the 80s.
If he's in it,
it's kind of like the president just trying
like
to go out and have ice
cream
and candy
arrived
when he
was
like 50.
Right,
that's the Pope.
It was like
he snuck out. To
Texas
help feed
child
the
like
that's
a
what he does.
Beauty pageant.
The dude's freaking awesome. I don't even know what his name
that's
is.
That's what it felt like to me.
No, yeah, like the Dalai Lama is just like there's
Dalai
been
Lama.
18
he's
million
awesome.
Of them.
I don't know,
but
he's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dolly motherfucking Lama.
Now I just want to go to Tampa and look at the Dolly exhibit.
Yeah, let's do that. Wait,
Dolly
I mean, we're
gonna
be living near there. We could just do like a road
trip.
Oh, are you guys moving? So wait.
Well, it might be like a year from now.
It's
going to
be
are you guys going to Georgia?
I want
to
go. You want to come?
12 months. I'm giving myself 12 months.
Visit.
She might be there. Aaron might be there.
You're not going anywhere, both of you. Boom, I said it.
Boom.
Thanks, naysayer.
Maybe we can do this radio show by Skype.
We can. We can.
We can
it's
make it happen.
It's definitely possible.
Oh, but what I was going to say before Mark suggested naysayer. Punching nuns.
Yeah, don't ever say that.
I was going to say, at least with Mark's belief of what he was just saying about family relationships and stuff, you have just earned yourself a slot on the list of Mark is never going to try to date you.
I win.
Yeah.
Yay.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. I wish people would just treat me. I wish
like
people would just
you.
Treat me as an orphan, because it makes more sense. Everything about me makes more sense if you just consider that she has no.
So that's really interesting too, because you're Persian, and they are super family oriented.
Right. See,
is your mom Persian?
Mm-hmm.
Is your dad?
Yes.
So interesting, because I know a lot of,
Aaron's laughing. Okay, can I just do it?
You might as well just go into
okay,
it.
Okay, so I'm just going to do this in like the quickest
it'll
way.
It'll be interesting
okay,
for our listeners.
Yeah,
like,
no, I'm just going
to
listen.
Rub my shoulders. So hello world. My name is Seraphim. I have a crazy fucking family background. So my name is not Sarah Peterson.
Ooh, I like
my
this
mother's
already.
Name is not her name.
Yeah.
My brother's name is not his name either. We were 100% Middle Eastern. came from Iran. I was born in Denmark. I was born on an island in little Copenhagen. It was all really
cool. Awesome.
But they were Muslim and they're crazy. And my father was a scientist and he got transferred to the U.S. for work. First, you know, to Europe and then to U.S. And
okay.
We transferred.
That's why you went to Copen.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's where we started. And then I was born and then we moved to Georgia.
Whoa, so you're from
Well,
Georgia.
But he was a dick. He was an awful human being at the time. And then some shit went down in Georgia, which is so fucking complicated that we're not even going to talk about it.
Got
but
it
was in the news. And he left the country. Mind you, at the time, they were not citizens. He was here on a work visa. And the shit that went down was not his fault. But he didn't know what the fuck was going on. He's not a citizen. So he just, like, he booked it, left the country. My mother, dealing with a lying, cheating bastard, decided to get a divorce. Which, when you're Muslim from Iran, you don't do that.
That yeah, that
ever.
Yeah, that's like killing a family member or something.
Well, that's what it actually
like
started
to
lead
to. Punching a nun in the throat.
Yeah.
My mother found out through one of her family members that overheard quote the men talking in another room. That they were. I didn't understand this until I was like in my 20s when I actually understood the world. Growing up, I just knew that they were going to hurt my mom and kidnap me and my brother. No, they were planning a fucking honor killing on my mom because of what she did.
What the fuck?
Yeah, this is legit shit, you guys. Like, it's a thing.
So witness protection?
Not even. Okay. Not That's even. We just ran.
Yeah, Iran doesn't
so,
have that program.
I get it?
We I know. Like, Iran.
Iran.
So far away.
That should totally be my theme song.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah,
or at least your mom's.
Yeah, one of the two.
But I mean, mind you, like, I mean, I was like, what, 3 years old? I was a fucking child. This is not my story.
Memory, yeah.
This isn't my story. I don't remember any of it. I don't remember much at all. But yeah, I mean, she found out. She was terrified. She ran. Some really awesome people took us in who were very, very well connected. They got our names changed. And they took us in as their own family. So my quote grandparents,
this is Mama
like,
P.
This is like Jewish, like the fucking
it's
Hitler's
like a pilgrimage.
But I mean, like the Holocaust.
You have to escape the.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's motherland. I mean, so this is the thing, though. So I mean, like, mind you, like I realized recently, like my mom at my age, she had like a 10-year-old and a 7-year-old,
and was running
for her life, and didn't speak good English, and got
Gives
taken in by his family, and had her name
Gives
changed.
Gives me fucking chills. That's
she couldn't.
Insane.
She couldn't contact her family in Iran. I mean, there is like some crazy shit. Like there is. I remember in high school, I'd never met my family, my like actual family, and I never wanted to. You have to understand. Like I grew up knowing not to ask about my father, and I didn't care. So people are like, oh, you're going to want to have to meet him someday. And I'm like, no, I literally don't give a fuck.
Yeah.
I have no want or yearning inside of me to ever meet my biological father because fuck him and fuck all of them. I am the whitest whitewashed Persian person you'll ever meet in your life. But
whitewashed person. I kind of want to make that like a.
Do you know any Farsi at all?
No. Name.
I can't even belly dance.
Whitewashed
awesome
Persian.
Dancing, but I can't belly dance.
Can you do those
I can't cook
with
the food.
The
no, I got nothing.
Oh, ching, ching, ching.
One of my old roommates, his name is Ali. He was actually like Middle Eastern. And he used like, we thought it was absolutely hysterical. Because he was like, he's like legitimately Middle Eastern. I'm Middle Eastern, but I have like
no
whatsoever.
Culture to it, yeah.
And so it'd be like this hysterical thing living with this dude and our white friend, Steve. And he'd be like, you're so fucking white, Sarah. He's like, you're the worst example of a Persian woman ever. Except you're a bitch, so that totally works. I was like, well, at least I have the rage running through my blood.
Yeah.
And so there's always like these really funny jokes where like, if someone pisses me off, I'm like, just because my last name is Peterson, don't think that I won't blow up your fucking car. Like, I'm Middle Eastern. I can say that.
She
and it's
not.
You have the
and
look
you
of a terrorist.
Very well should.
She's got the look of a terrorist. When you look at the
I
profile.
I am the hottest terrorist ever.
It's, there's shadiness going on in your mind. I know what's going on in there.
I know, honestly.
It's a matter,
a band name too,
it's a matter of national ever. Security. No one's looking at her. I'm scared for us
the
as Americans.
The new album from
on the 4th of July.
God
damn it, whitewashed Persians blow up the Empire State Building. That's the next movie Spielberg's going to make.
Honey, we like the U.S.
No,
we're the most
Bay.
Materialistic people in the
my
world.
My mistake.
Right?
Yeah.
It's a thing.
Interesting fact. In the United States, like, they're always dressed
so much bling.
Especially the ones out in L.A.
Much.
They've got, like, all the gold chains.
They smell like cologne.
But going back to the
family.
Going back to the family.
I'll never forget your first Persian record.
Oh, my God.
But going
that's
back
to
the
second
oh
track
my
God.
Of
the album.
Yeah, big dick Persians. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So going back. But going back to the family thing, you have to understand that. So yeah, I have a fucked up background. But don't think for one moment that I don't cherish and I want a family. I want that thing because mine has been
so fucked up.
My grandparents, my quote grandmother, is literally the only grandmother I've ever known. So even
the family that took you in.
Yeah.
Grandmother.
But it's not normal. So like, mind you, like my grandparents were divorced before they married each other. My grandma was never able to have children. So I'm practically like a daughter to her.
Mm-hmm.
My grandfather has children that I actually lived with at one point. And it's like this thing where it's like, that's not really he's not my uncle and he's not my brother.
Yeah.
He's my grandfather's son, Toby. Who's not my family. Like, it's a shitty thing. So, I mean, you guys say this whole thing about like, oh, you can tell a lot about a woman by how she treats her family. Well, if you come from something that fucked up, give me a family and I'm 100%.
Yeah.
We are going to punch a nun in the throat. Don't you and me together, baby.
Don't touch
the You and me.
You know what's going to happen?
I'm half Persian.
Mark and I are going
to walk. I'm half Persian, too.
Mark and I are going to walk into a Catholic church. He's going to attack
with
a nun.
With machetes.
He's going to attack a nun. I'm going to attack him.
Jesus.
And then, Aaron, we will finally be famous.
I know.
That's how I got there.
Natalie and I will just be roller skating outside.
Now I'm waiting for that to happen. So
with
it's not going to.
Confetti.
I got my defense.
Silly string.
Goddamn Persian 98-pound fucking Mexican. No fucking way will I put up with this.
Mexican.
Yeah, Persian Mexican. You know what's going to happen, though.
If there are any Persian Mexicans out there, I would love.
There is. Especially with
I bet you're right. I bet you're so
fucking it definitely happened.
You know what's gonna happen is this.
Come on now.
The three cops.
I'm actually really excited. There is a James Brown biopic coming out in August, and I'm really excited.
I love it. I can never understand what the hell he's saying.
Oh my God,
but it's
I love
exciting.
Him.
You don't get to drink.
I love him.
Mom. You are so out of line. You are so out of line.
I need
that's
to
the
make
point of this whole fucking podcast. To be out of line.
We could wrap it up if we want to just end it on an epic note of...
No, we're not done.
Okay.
I still have awkward stories.
No, Jesus. God damn it. Get me out of this.
Awkward, yeah.
Wait, did you actually have an awkward story for this week, or was it just a dream?
It was that actual thing. I took 3 Ambien, woke up in a mall, got beat up by cops. I was
backing off.
That was my awkward moment.
How are you not in
I don't know. The one with the fucking stores. Jesus Christ, you guys are being dicks. You guys are totally being dicks.
We are being dicks.
Get out.
Done. Let me dick whip your face with my dick.
With a straw?
No, with the dick I have because I'm such a dick right now.
So you punch
your microphone
like a bitch. Aaron, you're so hardcore.
I am. You gotta...
Wait, are we done? We're not really ending on my goddamn life.
Well, I don't. Tell me your awkward story, because I give a fuck.
Yeah, the only thing I was
that was not convincing.
You know, the three cops who tackled Mark were going to be on the news watching him, going, "Wow, it only took 2 girls to take him down in a church."
Right.
One of them's been in jail.
Natalie and I decided her and I are going to just be roller skating and playing with like confetti and silly string in front of this church.
Can you guys come in? Wait, can you guys be wearing those like 80s short shorts, roller skates, carrying a mini boombox, playing like 80s movies?
Oh, yeah.
While I'm trying to beat the shit out of Mark.
Mark as he's attacking a nun. Yeah,
and
we've got it.
Can the song that's playing be She's a Maniac?
Yes. Oh my, I'll totally do that like running move. Like, she's a maniac.
I don't know movies.
I love Flashdance.
I never saw it. And I
it's really not that great, but it's there's some iconic moments in it.
I know the iconic moments without even seeing the film. That's where our pop culture is at.
Well, because mind you, the movie's about a girl who works in the coal mines, but also works in a strip club after work. Somehow she's absolutely beautiful. And then some guy decides that she's gorgeous and really likes her and helps her get into dance school. But at the end of the movie, spoiler alert, she auditions.
And strips.
And it's great. But then it just ends with her hugging the guy and you're like, but did she get in? You never find out.
I think so.
She's a maniac.
By the hug.
Maniac.
But what is this movie? Is
oh, Flashdance.
Oh, yeah.
She's
extremely familiar.
I miss you so much, Noodle Pants. So
anyways, you do have a socially awkward moment this week.
I had multiple.
Okay.
Close the one down.
Close the one?
Maybe.
What?
Put on your head things, your ears.
Sure.
My stories are not nearly as epic as Natalie. Like we said, I am the poor man's Natalie. It's
stop it right now. There's no such thing.
Honey, a poor man's Natalie is still a
you're a
hot
different
thing.
Okay.
But like Natalie's a poor person's Natalie.
A poor, Natalie is a Natalie.
Natalie.
Yeah. She is the epitome of herself.
That's true.
Which
that's really weird because
she's
somebody
rich.
We'll talk about this later.
Okay.
Natalie's an entity.
No, somebody like
she's
said
like
that
Tatiana.
To me the other day. They were just like, no, you're the absolute epitome of yourself. And I was just like, okay, I take that as a good thing, but the way you...
I think they were trying to say that there's
no one else like you. Because
you're
saying, Aaron, you're a manic pixie dream girl. You are, honestly, like you're basically Zooey Deschanel in real life. It's a thing. She hates it, but it's totally true. She is everyone's manic pixie dream girl. It sucks, and you know it.
Yeah.
She looks like she's about to vomit. Yeah, she's vomiting into the microphone.
Oh, my God.
Right
that reminds me of that one picture that Mark took of her.
Because the thing is, like...
so hot.
That's such a good one.
So like, oh, my God. Whenever I'm sad...
I need to make an okay Cupid account with that.
But I'm just saying... Fuck you, Toby!
But,
damn
yes.
Cat.
Okay.
Don't make me get that.
No,
your awkward moment.
Mark
is trying to make it to an open mic event.
Oh, is that
which,
why?
If you want to say you're
open mic,
you
I mean
can
an open
oh my goddamn awkward moment. Let me make fun of it. Go.
Oh.
Boom.
Yeah. Or Mark, you could leave and just tune into the show.
Okay. Yeah. I'll listen.
Don't leave. He's like, okay, yeah.
You know. Well, there's options here.
There were just a couple. It was just a couple things. One of them that I was talking to Aaron about earlier.
Yes.
Because we've discussed, was this the being known thing?
Yeah.
Okay, that one. So I've said this before where multiple times throughout the time that I've been on this show, we've talked about like, God damn it, like it's so awful. I can't go anywhere without being recognized. Or
right.
The doppelganger.
The
thing.
Doppel.
There's the doppelganger. There's, I literally can't go anywhere without being recognized. Practically ruined one of my friend's birthdays because we went from bar to bar and every place we got interrupted because someone recognized me. That was a friend of mine. I'm like, oh my God, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
It's
so hard being so popular.
It's not even being popular.
Oh my God.
I'm like a social whore.
It sucks being so popular.
People
it's
just
a
see me.
Persian.
I'm
social
a happy
whore.
Persian.
I go out so often because I'm bored.
Yeah.
That other people are starting to recognize me everywhere. So now it's become, not only is it the doppelganger thing and the, I can't go anywhere without running into someone I know. Now it's, I can't go anywhere without running into people who are total strangers who know me, who recognize me and want to sit and talk with me.
Jeez,
and I don't know who,
so
know who
they are. Yeah.
No, it's not, it's
you
not
really
being
know
popular.
That Wicked song.
So. He's singing a Broadway song that's adorable.
Not a
sir,
that's Peter Gabriel.
No. Oh, nice.
Oh, God.
Oh, it's cool.
Damn it, I've dated myself.
How old are you?
You fucking children.
Should I get your walker ready for when you leave?
You damn kids, get off my lawn.
But you don't have a lawn.
So was it awkward because
your mailbox with my baseball bat.
So last week on, I think it was like a Friday night or a Saturday night, there was like a mini band festival thing happening at this place called the Red House Pub, or also known
as
Third Space.
Yeah.
It's off of 11th Avenue and Grand. It's really cute.
No! Is it close to Carson Wheeler's
It's literally on the corner. It's right across the street from the pizza joint.
Okay. Okay.
Right off of
the
11th
Grove?
Avenue.
Does that sound familiar?
I don't fucking know.
Okay, never mind.
It's literally on the corner of 11th Avenue and Grand. Like, right fucking there.
Yeah.
Right down the street from your house.
So, my friend Amber is in the band.
Which, by the way, now everybody knows how to find Natalie.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I'll be on the corner. sleeping on the bus stop. Many
hooker. Son of
a little booty short.
Selling your wares. Look at you.
She just wants to get back to jail.
Look at you.
She wants to get back to jail.
That's all you know. You only know the
inside. That's all I know.
It's all you know.
Dude, the vending machines? Don't get me started. Anyway.
Let's close this deal.
So I was talking to Aaron about this because we have this issue. We all have a common issue as.
All of us. Mark has it even more than we do.
I got way more issues than all three you combined.
But here's the thing.
Okay?
Here's the thing. Here's the thing, though.
You're the producer. Produce this shit.
But Mark, here's the thing.
Steve.
Mark.
Steve.
The thing is like when people ask you who you are actually someone. Like you do something that puts you in the spotlight. You've been seen. There is no reason to know who the fuck I'm a goddamn nobody. I am a goddamn nobody. It's totally fine. It's not like some insecurity thing. I work in insurance. Like, I'm really not that big of a deal. The fact that people recognize me really does freak me out. But so I worked the doors at this show at this venue. They had like 11 bands, big old show. There was Decker and Dry River Yacht Club closed it out.
Oh, yeah.
My friend Amber is in Decker, and she's like, we need someone to work the doors. Like, can you please help
Johnson? I love her.
Yeah,
absolutely,
you know Amber Johnson?
Fucking love
She's
her.
One of my best friends.
She's one of my favorite
Isn't
people
like
on the planet.
She's the cutest person ever, Amber.
I can
you.
Text her the
Aww.
Most inappropriate
oh, yeah,
fucked
she's
up
adorable.
Shit, and she comes at me with, wow, this chick knows.
Oh, yeah, she's magic. No.
I meet her.
She's magic.
She's like Aaron. She's a manic pixie dream girl. Like, guys just fall for her. She just knows what she's doing.
Nice.
It's amazing. But we love you, Aaron. We're always going to talk about you. But so I'm just sitting there, like, I take over the front door. I'm talking to the bouncers. I introduce myself to the venue owner. I find out who's organizing the whole event, making sure that I'm at the front. This is my jam.
Yeah.
I own it. It's awesome. Making charge, do whatever. But at the end of the night, everything's done. I'm sitting with Amber, and we're just like, oh my God, we're exhausted. I've literally been working for 6 hours. The first three of them were in the hot sun.
Yeesh.
I'm exhausted and dehydrated.
Melting.
Did not drink enough that evening. So we're sitting on the patio. Everything's done. We're just chilling. These people, these men, kept following me. And they were like, oh yeah, I saw you at that one show at the mill 3 months ago.
At the mill.
And yeah, you know the mill on Tempe?
I think it was over 3 months ago. It was over 3 months ago.
They had like a
it's
big.
It's your own fault. You brought it on yourself.
It's okay.
Okay, no, I just went to a fucking show. And the guy's like, yeah, you know this chick Liz, and I saw you there. And I'm like, that's great. Like, I don't know you.
Like, I don't remember that person.
And so he follows me around the venue, and he keeps following me. And then because he's talking to me, and he keeps like, no, don't you remember? Don't you remember? And I'm literally sitting there going, dude, like,
that's why you carry
a
taser.
I'm not trying to be rude, but like,
I
meet so many people. I met you once over 90 days ago, and you expect me to remember you. I'm not trying to be rude, but seriously, like, I don't expect anyone to remember me.
I do a lot of heroin, so I can't remember you.
I'm sorry. So I'm so high.
Yeah. Junkie.
All fucking
time.
I'm sorry. I've been having this really terrible bout of syphilis.
But the thing that was super creepy is like, I'm sitting with Amber. This dude's keeps
on
fucking
you.
Talking to me. But his conversation with me, which I'm just trying to like make stop. but his conversation, someone else overhears it, joins the conversation. He goes, no, dude, I recognize her too. Do you hang out at Crescent?
Oh, shit.
And I'm
who
like,
the fuck that
oh
is
my God,
in
you
the
guys.
The music
like,
scene at all has never been to Crescent. That's my question.
Like,
yeah.
And they're like,
who
no.
involved in the local music scene has never been to the Crescent
and
ballroom?
Like, and I'm not trying to be a bitch. It's just, I really don't like talking to strangers.
Yeah.
I really don't. I don't like talking to strangers ever.
Yeah.
I'm a nice person.
But apparently you do, because that's how they know you. I don't know.
No, yeah. I don't remember ever talking to them. Like, I remember being at the show at the mill when there was like that big show. I hung out with my friend Skylar and I hung out with my friend Liz.
Yeah.
And I remember maybe saying, hello, my name is to everyone else.
Oh, just like meet from other friends.
And that was it. So that was my awkward thing. It's just I'm
you're like, I don't know who these people are, but they know me. No. They like take
bye,
them.
Mark. We love you.
He Mark, gave wait. A little purr. No, he's got an open mic thing he has to get to. So,
he's cooler than
so
he hasn't
but that's
was,
why
but that
he
was my awkward moment.
That is pretty awkward. Where
it's gone from doppelganger recognition to can't go anywhere yeah. without my friends.
Which actually
me.
Makes me think of a noodle bee story where you was it in a coffee shop. You were asking a woman how you knew them, and you were like, "No, did we go to high school together?
Oh,
I totally
yeah.
saw you
and
cry
it was,
before."
It was the girl from
the Bachelor.
No, it was the girl from The Notebook.
Oh,
who in the movie was?
I never saw that.
Ryan. So. Girlfriend, anyway. But yeah, it was weird.
Someone tell me who Jim Swofford is.
I do not. Jim.
He's your friend. Is he my friend? I just received a text from him going, "I must tell you that your pick title, Bitch Face, is a complete arousal. If that was what you were going for, you nailed it. The things I do to you." Jim, who the fuck are you?
Whoa, Jim. Easy now, Jim.
How did he send you a text?
Facebook.
Oh, Facebook
instant message. This is not, what are those websites called?
Grindr.
This is not Grindr.
Apparently, that's actually for gay guys. Tinder.
Apparently the only reason why I know him, I guess, is from
the network.
Mark.
Okay.
Can I tell him that
so
I just made fun of him?
He's a Mark friend.
He's got to be one of Mark's friends.
Is he hot?
I'm totally making. I'm going to let
why
him know that
asking?
I'm making fun of him.
Oh, yeah. You know what's actually really funny is a couple weeks ago, a lot of times I get Facebook friend requests from people that I don't know, and I just assume that it's because they actually give a shit about the podcast, so I friend them. And it was really funny because Sarah and I were on our way up to Jerome for like a little day trip, and I was telling her about this private message that I got, and I was like, "Yeah, this guy who I didn't really know, but we have a lot of mutual friends, da 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 da. He sent me this message." And it was all about like, "Oh, I'm sure you've been through a lot, but I'm sure you're a good person and just like have a great day and da 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 da."
Whoa.
Turns out verbatim sent the same message to Sarah, and I was like, "Okay, well now this just feels cheap."
Yeah.
Yeah.
So some random person just friended all these random people and then sent
and
to everyone
and like, positive, happy.
I know guys,
I bet you
didn't
do
like,
that. He's trying to be fucking deep.
Yeah.
And then it's like, wait. You cheap whore.
Wait, yeah. Oh, so July 10th, what are you doing, baby?
You.
What's happening July 10th?
Whiskey Shivers is playing the Rogue Bar, and if you're free from
3
p.m. to 3 a.m.
Yeah. Wait, what day is it?
I don't know. The 10th.
Is that a Saturday?
I don't fucking know. Do I look like a calendar?
You have a phone.
Tomorrow is the 4th.
Use
it's
your goddamn
phone.
It's
6 days from tomorrow.
Natalie,
use your phone.
So it'll be a...
I have sausage fingers
from tomorrow, though.
You said the 10th.
Yeah, the
10th. The 10th is on a Thursday.
What? All right, so Thursday at the Rogue Bar,
today
baby.
Thursday?
Yes.
Wait.
Okay,
yes.
I slept like an accumulative
well,
of like...
I just was trying to help you out and I pulled
no,
it
yeah, I know. I know.
She
I'm sorry.
She slept as long as a raindrop lasts on the sidewalk.
She gives me shit for it.
Yeah, I'm going to shit all over this.
Wait, what? Ew, Aaron, can we... Seriously, you girls. And
sorry,
we're
very shitty.
Literal shit.
We're shit talkers. Don't mess with Noodle Bee and Aaron, okay?
Yeah,
Noodle and Moo, we're shit talkers.
We get gross.
We get
oh,
shitty.
Can we rename the show to that, Noodle and Moon?
Noodle and Moo, that's what our Twitter is. Like, that's what I call us.
Noodle Moo.
Noodle Moo.
It's a new Vietnamese dish.
It's really tasty. It's
you try Noodle Moo right now.
Noodle Moo.
So good.
So spicy.
All you can eat Noodle Moo.
Really,
spicy.
Spicy make you double spice.
It really good. It's really good.
Yeah. But I think
We're good. Yeah. I mean, it's been a good.
Happy birthday, America.
Yes.
America.
And I am thankful to be here because even as a female, even though there are certain legislations that want to strip my rights, at least it's better than being born female in other countries where you're going to get murdered
you
right
have
away.
No
like
rights.
Texas.
And you have no rights.
Yeah.
So, you know, land of the free-ish.
Free-ish. Yeah.
But better than being land of the, oh.
Not, oh. Mm-mm. Oh, no.
run.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we love you guys. Thank you for
listening on as always.
And
yay, Natalie's back.
Noodle,
so happy.
I missed you guys. Noodle is free-ish.
And all you listeners out there, definitely, I mean, if you guys are having fun, if you're laughing,
be safe.
Please tell your friends.
Oh, yeah,
have them listen
you.
To us. Yeah.
And like the Facebook.
Tell your friends. Find us on Facebook. What's our Facebook?
It's just basically Facebook.
Underground Railroad
www.facebook /Underground
Keep
Railroad.
Keep this lily pad afloat. But yeah, tell your friends, listen to us while you're driving around, being awesome, getting drunk.
Yeah.
Have fun with us.
Exactly.
Talk about us. Make fun of us. It's all good.
Right. And make sure to let Sarah know who she is when you find her in public. At least tell her it's from the Underground Railroad.
Well, no one will want to talk to you. No one will recognize
Not
me. All the photos that. Posted, yeah. I look. Ridiculous.
She always says she looks ridiculous.
I do look ridiculous.
Whatever. Please. Bitch, please. You just said your mama makes pretty babies.
Well,
you be one of them.
Other pretty babies.
Oh, shut your mouth. Shut your mouth.
Shush it, hush.
Hush, child.
Shush, hush.
Hush.
Hush. Girls, you're white.
All right.
Whatever.
Not today. All right. All right.
Rowdy, howdy, good night.
Mwah.
Bye.
Did we do okay?
Born through a party in the county jail. The prison band was there. They began. The band was jumping and the joint began to swing. You should have heard this knocked out jailbird sing. Let it rock. Everybody let it rock. Everybody in old cell block was dancing to the jail out rock. Spider-Man.
This has been another fine production of the 4i Radio Network. For more great shows, check out www.4iradio.com.
You're the brunt, I'm the punchline. When the trains run out of tracks, well, I never get you back. You're such a bitch. You hurt my feelings. All my love for you, I will never tell the truth. Except for here. Straight jacket, baby, just like getting your head clear. Why am I lost when it comes so sincere? I mean, right now I say to you, living and dying for you, but the next day always comes. I'm the train wreck, and the one thing that I know is I got to let you go. Oh, but I can't. I'm such a pussy. All my love for you, I will never tell the truth, except for hair. Jacket, baby, just to get in your head clear. While I've been lost, well, it costs so sincere. Me right now, say to you, living down for you, but the next day always comes, baby. I'm the punchline, and the one thing that I know, one thing that I know, self for hair. Straight jacket, baby, just to get in your head clear. Why I'm at a loss, well, it costs so sincere. Next day, I'll be
Howdy, rowdy, y'all. So we're doing a special edition of the Underground Railroad tonight. We've been hanging out at the Time Out Lounge out here in Tempe, Arizona. Been doing the Sunday service.
Listen to some awesome local music.
I love
music.
This place.
So Mark was the first set. Casey is here with us.
Hello.
And he's actually the one who got us here this afternoon, this fine evening. So we've just been hanging out at the bar all day. Some of our friends came and hung out with us too. And that was nice of you to come. Hey!
Oh,
this smells good. I'm not stealing it. I just want to sniff it.
You can sniff it.
This is all trivia. I was better than Led Zeppelin tonight.
Yeah,
isn't that weird that I could fucking pull that shit off?
You were.
I was like, oh, you know, I knew, you know, I've been doing it for a while, and I realized I kind of, you know, I had it in me, but it
channeled.
Happened.
It was pretty legit. That's why I had a shitty set, because you fucked it up for the.
It was, you know,
for the rest of us.
Yeah, I brought pyrotechnics.
Can we say the F word?
Yeah, sure.
Whatever you want.
It's podcast shit, man.
Thanks for messing it up for me.
What, you know, you
I tried to do good, but I'm like, I can't do Led Zeppelin good.
All I'm saying is you said it was going to be acoustic. You didn't say I couldn't bring a smoke machine. I couldn't bring
lasers.
You didn't say that. And the lasers, I didn't know, you know, I would have left them up for you, but you didn't say anything. So
you didn't realize you smoked the moment. You didn't realize your smoke machine went out halfway through a set, so I was just doing bong hits behind you. That's where your smoke machine came in.
It's never easy to follow a strong act, right? You had to really bring it.
Ever allowed lasers or smoke machines, because Mark and I just messed everyone up. I keep wanting to say F, but I say mess. Thanks, dude, for just messing up. Yeah. No more smoke machine or lasers.
We almost had to evacuate the building for the short that happened in the fog machine.
I think he had I could see
more about puppies, you guys.
Puppies and fire alarms and evacuations.
There's this podcast that talks about toxology, and there was a toxology report about when you mix the wrong fluids into your smoke machine, and I think that happened tonight because I almost died.
I felt so metal, though.
It was cool, though, because I kind of had to resuscitate Aaron, so there was girl-on-girl action happening.
What a...
If Ronnie James Dio was still alive, he would have wanted to kiss you on the cheek.
That's the degree of metal.
Well, I mean, he sings about rainbows, and he's still as metal as can be.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
So, Casey, you've got a really cool endeavor that you just embarked on.
I have.
Chili Bees.
I just opened a business that is a mobile cold brew coffee cart. It's a cart. It's not a food truck. People kind of just go, is it a cart?
Kind of like the hot dog stands in front of like Home Depot.
Way cooler than that. I can still go where the food trucks go and serve cold brew coffee. Anybody doesn't know what about cold brew coffee, it's not an iced coffee. Iced coffee is heated espresso poured over ice. That's why it still tastes bitter. That's why you still need sugar and cream. My coffee takes minimum 12 hours to brew, so you don't need... I have yet to use sweetener in my coffee. You know what I'm saying? Yes.
Cooper, get in here. We got coffee talk.
I just met a girl.
I'm just on my own.
Are you on your own?
Yeah.
I heard someone else saying that they were going to do this, but if you get on it first, you're going to like...
Well, no, there's nothing wrong with being competition or anything.
Want to join the show?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, get in on this.
What are we talking about?
All right, this is one of our...
We're talking about Casey's...
We're talking about my business.
Right now.
Your business.
Sorry.
My business.
Hi.
I don't have my head.
So we're currently talking about Casey's cold brew adventure.
Yeah,
it's a business. It's mobile.
Okay.
I can go inside. I can be outside. If you want coffee served to whoever.
On my mobile phone.
God,
you want coffee on your
phone? Can they find
you're
you
brilliant, Cooper.
You can find me online. ChiliBee.net, Facebook, Chili Bees Flavor Station, Instagram, Chili Bees Flavor Station, Twitter, ChiliBeeFS. Chili Bees Flavor Station.
Are all of the names plural except for the last one?
Nope. The business name is B plural Bees, but everything else you don't aren't allowed to do it.
Bez.
So just Chili Bee Flavor Station. Look that up. Hire me.
because I'm broke and I need the business.
Do you want to talk about your music a little bit?
Yes, I play chords in succession and with lyrics.
What's your favorite chord progression? Because I've got mine.
G, E,
H,
F, G, B flat, okay. D minor,
okay.
Seventh minor over 15th fret F.
Yeah, you lost me.
Shouldn't play with
what's
minor.
Your favorite chord progression, Mark?
That's fucking jazz, baby.
G.
That is.
G.
Just G. Why do you need
Tyler,
to go beyond G?
You
G. That's it. G.
Well.
I did.
I'm going to fucking hang on G to the end of time
what
and
run
a motherfucker pop
favorite.
Monster. Because yeah. That's how I roll.
Pop monster.
People at the table.
So Tyler and
Derek
hey. Just arrived.
Hi.
Mark, Casey, and Tyler all performed earlier.
Give me some beer, Mark.
It's. Going, you're
please.
You heard their music.
I don't mean to demand things.
Show. Your favorite chord progression.
My favorite chord progression. I'm gonna try to give my most honest answer, and I would say I love the C A minor F G.
Yeah,
I love that loop. I love that loop. I swear to God.
That's
I'll steal
like
that.
That's like my go-to.
Yeah.
I'll steal
I know.
Capoed on the fourth fret.
Okay.
And that
I was just about to make a capo question because I know Mark has told me in private before. Is it okay for me to let the interweb world know this? That you don't do power chords, you just. You have
I don't know
bar
chords.
You
I don't know
power chords. Aren't good for
I love that loop. I'm
you don't
I
use power chords in acoustic.
I slide that capo up into the fucking
and then all of a sudden
and just go, there's my fucking chorus.
Yeah.
You know, that kind of thing.
That's like home for me.
Yeah,
fourth
yeah,
fret,
yeah.
C position.
Yeah,
that's,
yeah fourth
that's
fret. Money.
See, I'm more third fret, but that's all right. Everyone has their own. It's all.
Everyone
what happens
own.
Is if whatever fits. It's what you're comfortable singing. It all is about
your
vocal
fifth
tenor.
Fret,
it's a sweet spot.
So fourth,
find sweet spot.
Fourth usually means you have a lower register because the higher you go, the lower something like that. Whatever.
I could have been a dancer.
Fucking
black
set.
Could have. I'll just choreograph your next music video, Mark.
That's what I need.
No.
Did we mention we're at Timeout Lounge for a Sunday service and acoustic matinee for day drinkers?
Yes.
It's a tagline. I had to put it in there once.
Very good. Very good. Okay, the whole thing with writing a song is
it's always about chicks.
This is
always about
chicks.
All girls, you know?
I don't give a fuck.
You can say
whatever you want. It's always about chicks.
In a way.
Sing songs about crazy ladies tonight.
Because all you girls are crazy. It's just at what level? Is it ping pegged at 9 or is it 3?
I played a song about freaks. And that's not just about girls. I think there's guys and girls. I there's people that are like kind of freaky that I like, but they're like beautiful at the same time. So I call them beautiful
freaky
freaks.
Beautiful?
Beautiful freaks or freaky beautiful, however you want to call it.
Kind of like Tumblr.
Kind of like that?
It's like Tumblr.
Yes.
Joe Cooper, everybody.
Hi.
You know, it just makes me think about that song, like, all of the people.
I'm
going to
follow you.
People.
Yeah. With the hi-hat and
like,
but the good, you, when you need a spark, it's always a girl will get you going on a tune. It's like, I mean, I don't know if there really is any other kind of song besides a love song. I mean, if you think about it.
Well, the song's about drugs, too. Let's be real.
Well, if you love drugs, it's still
a love
song.
Girls are drugs.
Wrong. He's right, because anything you write about is usually something you love or hate. And if it's hate, you still love. There's a love aspect because if you hate it because you used to love it. Right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Maybe it's something about. Maybe it's something you hate. It's about something you hate, but then it turns out to be a really good song, so you love it.
Well,
okay.
We can
love it, love to hate it.
Casey,
yeah,
exactly.
But you know what? All I have to say about all of this is, fuck you, bitch. You don't get the publishing.
Please.
I do. I will get that place for the movie. I will fucking goddamn. Charlie Sheen will be fucking acting over my goddamn song, motherfucker.
So earlier tonight, you, Casey, made a Radiohead cover. And I remember an interview I read years ago with Tom York where he talks about certain songs that he writes where it's like, once it's been recorded and put on an album, he's over it. Like, and it's kind of like that chapter in your life, you write the song, you make it a full song, you let go of it and it's done, which maybe that's why I never finished.
That's kind of like
songs.
Life.
So what's the,
you know, it's
the
weird.
Question?
It's she has a question.
So my question is when you guys are talking about, like, okay, crazy things, even if it's not an individual, you're, it's almost therapy in a sense, yeah, of like, okay, this is why you.
Yeah. So I'm confused. Yeah. What is your question?
Are there songs of yours that you wrote that now, like, you never want to play again?
Yes.
Which,
totally.
Did you play
you didn't hear any of those songs.
I heard
there are some because of the fact that they're either meant to be.
Understand.
No, I get it. They're either meant to be a period in your life that is hard, but I will eventually always. I have one in particular that I've been holding off. It's such a good song, but every time I play it, I'm like, ugh. It just makes me.
I got a spin on that. Listen, I've gone through that whole thing, and I'm up there. I'm 47 years old, so I. What I'm saying is like, you go through that period where you don't want to touch that tune because it would touch you in an emotional way in your timeline of your life, and it was kind of a weird thing. And it was like, oh, you couldn't get, but you eventually get over all of this. Every moment that you wrote a song, every fucking poignant moment that made you write a song, you will get over that and come back to that.
Yeah.
And it's like, that is what will happen to all of you, my children.
Well, I'll play that song once again.
Anything to say on this subject?
I think one of the best, pieces of advice or whatever. Well, it was not like personal advice to me, but I think it was Neil Young said. He's never wrote a song that he's never wrote his favorite song yet. Something along those lines, and to me that just made a lot of sense, because it's like, you might feel like, man, I just finished this song and it's freaking great, it's like the best thing I've ever done, and then like 3 or 4 months go by and you're like, man, that song sucks.
Yeah. It's the worst thing I've ever fucking done.
You know?
No, yeah, and you know what, I think the curse would be what Neil Young said: once you realize you have written the best song you ever wrote, there's no reason
to go after that.
Yeah. So,
the
artist's brain,
a better song.
The artist's brain is such a roller coaster of.
Yeah.
My favorite chord progression
was LMNOP, and I wrote it in Capo, Mexico. So.
Capo, Mexico. I think that's 15th fret, right?
I think it's the best.
It was
the minor.
Thanks for explaining my thought for me.
Okay.
Because you interrupted halfway through my thought. You're like, I got it. I'm going to. No, but okay. You know what? He was right.
He was pretty spot on with it.
Thanks for. Can I bring you anywhere? If I'm like going to talk to a girl, I'll just go, hi, my name's Casey. And then
here's my comment.
And then Mark goes in and she's like, okay. And she looks at me and she goes,
Mark,
and then 10 minutes later she goes, I'm going to sleep with you. Thanks, Mark.
I can chuck the fuck out of anyone in a weird manner.
You can make money doing that.
Mark's kind of your pimp now.
I just have to look cute and then you just.
He's a good wingman.
Mark's your wingman.
You know what? Mark and I have the same exact contract.
What?
I just have to look cute, and he
no
makes
that.
All of my.
I make the noises.
You know? Like, all of my best dates I've had thanks to Mark Norman.
If you can get by with good looks.
Aaron Mooney
didn't
exist until 2003.
I disagree with that.
And you were like, you know.
I feel like
I was way prior.
I pulled you out of a cryogenic laboratory.
You don't know this. I'm announcing this live.
So I'm your
Powerpuff Railroad. I pulled her out of a cryogenic laboratory. In 2003. Sorry, Steve, it's not your sister.
Aaron, that explains.
Sorry, bro. Bro.
My entire life has been a lie.
Aaron's having a moment. I'm going to cuddle her.
I'm adopted?
It's okay, baby girl.
I'm not even human.
Cooper adopted you.
Oh, damn.
Okay, we're wrong.
How does that work with our potential elope?
I like how people can't see how many furrowed brows are happening.
I know. We've been discussing that we need to get a webcam involved in our...
The keys.
Last week, there were a lot of things thrown at Mark's head.
And we really need to have
them.
The
balls.
Did anyone... No one on air can understand why.
Are we talking about balls on your skull?
People need to witness that.
Yeah.
I'm just sitting in that teabag, Mike.
Did I you say it's my first time on the podcast?
I wish I had water balloons right now. I would be throwing water balloons at every one of you. You know why? Because I'm going to win this podcast. You can't beat me. I will talk over you.
Because you talk closest to the mic like this, I'm pretty sure.
If you haven't listened to the Underground Railroad before, something that we do is we share awkward things that happen during
awkward
the week. So
the
if
week.
We want to go around and talk
awkward,
about
well,
awkward moment of the
where
week.
Do we start?
Oh my God.
Who's going to start us off?
Am
most
I?
Most awkward yeah. moment in the last 7 days.
7 days?
Yeah.
Or your lifetime, really.
Oh.
You just
you're
want to pull
new,
anything.
So
7 days. It's when Mark Norman watched me pee tonight.
Some
that was
life devastating
Aaron.
Moment.
It's never awkward for
every
me. It's just awkward for
you.
Everyone else involved.
It was when Mark Norman watched me pee, and I'm like, hey, dude. And he goes, he kind of looked over my arm to go see. And he goes, it's good to see you, too. So that was the most awkward moment. I think he wanted, I don't know.
That was you?
Yeah, that was
you? Oh, my God. I thought
you weren't
black.
Even looking in my
I
face.
I thought you were a black man. That's weird.
With a white penis?
Hey,
you didn't
happened.
Look at my
there's
eyes.
There's always been a
I
lie.
I feel
though.
Cheap because you didn't even look at my eyes. All you did was look at my dick and then you walked out.
What
I felt
talking
shh.
About.
Jesus. If I had
the
a
time
nickel.
You were in the bathroom.
He didn't even have
me.
To pee.
I don't even know what you're
he's
about.
Denying it. See, I knew he would deny it. I knew he would deny it.
Mark didn't even
up.
Have his fly down. He was just
you watched me pee. That was
thing,
the most awkward
you know,
moment.
Making his rounds.
This just happened like an hour.
I would rather
come maybe you shouldn't pee on the pool table.
There was a moment earlier today where Mark did say, I hate that all the dicks are bigger than
dicks
my dick.
Me.
That was right after I was talking to the girl. That was right after
I was talking to the girl, too.
That's
the
fucking
thing.
I'm just saying. I just
talked.
You asked me a question. I answered it.
Fucking Sunday. Shit.
Sunday service.
I just happened to make up the story, but that's all I got.
Someone wrote dick bills.
I saw that. I wonder what it meant, and I was also like, does that mean I should tip?
I'm going to go to the restroom and get paid, but I'll be right back.
Should we go to our next? Well, so, David, I'm an awkward.
Save my seat.
Man, I can't really think of anything in the past 7 days awkward.
Or maybe just your life.
I think a lot of times I thrive on awkward situations, though. I actually like.
I like many things intentionally
awkward
just because I don't care.
Well, okay,
where
I could.
My best comedy comes from.
One just kind of came to mind actually. I had this really good conversation with my bandmate just a couple nights ago, saying.
Everybody's dick is bigger than Mark Norman's in Tempe.
We were talking about Mark Norman.
It's your name,
Mark
Norman.
Norman.
I mean, yeah.
Might be it.
There we go.
You are
my awkward moment is happening right now.
Yes.
Which is
I gotta throw that plug in there, right?
Great local group.
Oh, thank you. Yes.
I enjoy you.
Oh, I appreciate it. Yeah.
I thought your songs made your ass look fat, but you know, I'm just trying to share your dick.
Are they about girls or are they about drugs?
The big booty hoe before.
I found it interesting that during your set you were like taking turns drinking beer and then following it with iced coffee.
I know.
And then
weird?
Going back to beer and I'm like, that. But if you made
is
it work, you were
like
happy.
Speedballing?
It's like I love drinks. I like drinks like all kinds of drinks. I like
all the liquids.
I just like drinks. Sometimes I can't make up my mind.
If I sat like a venti iced water and dish soap and a straw in front of you, you would just drink it.
I mean, at least for the experience, right?
Maybe
if
it's
the only thing in front of you to drink, you would just do it.
Yeah, if I
he'd be singing and like bubbles would be coming out of his mouth while he's singing, it would just add to the show.
See, that would be cool though.
I have a sometimes
like
I have
Sarah
a
Robinson
too,
should incorporate that.
I love her.
Bubbles. I heard they just lost their guitar player. They found
what's
someone
that?
New.
Your awkward moment.
It's kind of an awkward moment. It's where we had a conversation a couple nights ago.
Such as Tempe.
Where we were talking about, yeah, we really got to give up drinking. We got to, like, this music thing is, like, it's really easy to fall into this trap of, like, getting drunk after shows and this and that. And I was like, yeah, man, you know, I'm really kind of done with it all, like, as far as drinking. And we go out last night to a bar, And the first question is, hey, you know, what can I get you to drink? And of course, we're at an ale house.
Everything.
So everything that I said goes out the window, and my bandmate's sitting right there looking at me, and he's like, what about this, like, whole conversation that we had? And then I naturally ordered a beer, and it was just like,
I
don't know if that's awkward.
I can actually wait for you to, like, make this epic change in your life, and it failed.
I can actually relate to that very well, because Natalie, who is usually on this podcast, she had to work tonight. There have been many times when her and I were roommates where, like, we were like, we're going to go on a cleanse, and we, like, plan it all out. We're just like, yeah, we're doing the lemonade cleanse. Or like, oh, we're going to go on a raw vegan diet for a month. And, like,
raw,
we're not going to.
Did you say raw bacon?
We're going to, yeah, we're going on a raw bacon
that's what
diet.
I heard. I'm sorry.
I can't even do bacon when it's cooked. So, like.
What?
We were talking about this earlier.
I can't do bacon.
All the bacon.
You're ridiculous. It's fucking ridiculous.
What's the song about bacon?
Money? Really?
But, yeah, like, the second we come home, it's like,
oh, wow, thank you.
I want a beer, I want a glass of wine, and we just immediately go. And we're like,
it's probably just best.
Can we talk about the money
we
just made?
Yeah, exactly.
Let's talk about the big fucking dollars that we just made.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't want to. I'm done. I'm done with the interview. I got paid, so I'm going to have to leave.
Yeah. You're going to drive over to Jack in the Box.
That's all I was
spending on.
This is all I was waiting
for. Let me just talk about Sunday service getting massive. The artists get paid top dollar at Sunday service. Look at that.
I have
a
major doctor.
You got free drinks and you made lots.
Not enough free drinks. Let's not look
at
it.
Easy.
Since you're on air, you have a chance to promote. Are you guys playing anywhere else?
Every Sunday here.
You're playing every Sunday here?
And then Tyler's going to make a thing at Rhythm Room that he's going to book me on.
Yeah, well, yes. If I have some kind of connection, I want to do a singer-songwriter night at, like, a local venue where make it kind of a weekly series where we kind of, like, sit up at, like, have three or four songwriters up on stage and just kind of talking in between songs, explaining songs, and taking turns in between songs, and kind of have like a back porch kind of thing.
It's like an in the round.
Almost even like VH1 storytellers.
Storytellers, yeah.
Storytellers
in the round.
Yeah.
Where everyone still is up there. So Tyler's playing a song. He tells a story. He plays a song. We all sit and listen to him. And then the next guy goes, Okay, so you tell your story, and you play a song, and I play a song, and then we all, like, clap, and then we all kiss.
Aww.
And we do, and we smoke a joint.
I was looking at your dick. What was that?
I don't know. Did you guys come to something like that?
Like, what the fuck were you talking about?
My most awkward moment is literally right now.
Jesus Christ. Is Mark still on talking about my penis?
Yeah. Mark's going to be talking about your dick for weeks.
Dude, I made it up. I made it the whole fucking thing.
Don't tell our listeners that
it's still my most
awkward
moment of the week.
I totally made it up.
I just lost all of my credibility.
I think the most awkward moment was him.
You never had any credibility, Aaron.
I think the most awkward thing was Mark assuming that you were true when you said it. Him thinking, like, this happened and I forgot.
That's my act. I should be a fucking actor. I should be an actor. I'm an actor.
So, the storytellers being the songwriter storytelling event, when do you think this might...
That's the problem. I have to figure out when it could be done, and there's a few people that I could talk to that I could get in touch with, that book at the Rhythm Room. So that's kind of up in the air. That's just where my brain is going. We do have a show, Mr. Mudd and Mr. Gold. We do have a show this Tuesday.
Crescent Ballroom,
July 15th. And it's for my birthday.
What's the date for that? Which, happy birthday, Leo.
Cancer.
Oh, shit.
Wait, it's your birthday?
That's right, because my mom's birthday is
Tuesday. Tuesday's
going to
be my
cancer.
Real
birthday.
Where
are you playing?
The Crescent Ballroom.
Okay,
what day?
You're coming.
Tuesday. Crescent Ballroom, Mr. Mudd and Mr. Gold.
Tell me I'll plug in on KWSS.
Oh, tell him what?
Tell me. Tell me and I'll plug it on KWSS.
Hey, let's plug. How about you plug
93.9?
Sunday service.
Sunday service.
7 on your FM motherfucking dial from 6 o'clock in the a.m. to 10 o'clock in the fucking
AM. Did you, hey, did you plug your show here on KWSS?
I don't know.
Oh, you don't know?
I probably did.
Come on. Did you? Yeah. Or did you? Okay.
Yeah.
Are you lying to me?
I'm not lying to you. Of course I did.
You wouldn't want to lie to me. You've already looked at my penis, so you don't want to lie to me.
Jesus Christ. God, you would like
so
to
I
want to
share my awkward moment of the week.
Oh yeah,
hey Mark, we have another awkward moment.
I want to share
mine.
Just
because something's not awkward doesn't mean anything.
You know,
it happened earlier during your set, actually.
That happens a lot.
I asked Mark if he wanted to dance with me, and he told me he will not dance with me until our wedding night, which apparently I'm engaged to Mark Norman.
Gave you $5 to buy a wheel
and have a chance
that represented
that's
an engagement ring.
Our
circles.
But
CSS
you
circles,
gave you bought me that shot after you told me you wouldn't dance with
it.
Me until our wedding night.
It's whatever. It was
and now I'm just thinking I need to marry.
I want to know. Okay, at what point do you lose your kidney? Is that before you get married? Is that after you get married?
Yeah.
Funding the marriage?
Whatever. I've always loved you. Don't be worried about it.
But I'm just wondering, do we need to, like, go ahead and get married and then, like, I do my first divorce and I can run along the terms of being the next Elizabeth Taylor?
Listen, can I tell you, can I speak
so
to
So you're going to be my first failed marriage?
Can I get down on one knee right now at this given point in time?
I'd like to know if you're physically capable of doing that.
Knee at this point, and I'm looking up at Aaron, but I feel so weird because her fucking brother is producing this show and he's
sitting right behind
you.
All I wanted was a dance partner during the end of your set, and apparently
I'm
now
engaged down.
To
it was heartbreaking.
Really? You should have just came up and danced.
And
right?
I was like shimmying in the booth.
I was
shimmying
in the booth,
I feed
you
off
don't
people.
Dance. You dance?
I do. I love to dance.
You lying dancer.
No.
Fucking mother lying dancer.
Which, you know what? Next time I'm just going to dance, and I'm not going to invite other people to dance with me, because apparently now
I
got traded $5 for my engagement.
Let's all do the falsetto thing. Ah!
I come to the
right in the background while we're doing that.
I don't want to do is just
okay.
Cry.
Well, I'm going to ask all four of you right now. I'm going to ask you a question. Okay. It's four of you.
Oh, four.
Jesus, it's the new math. Don't worry, we'll work it out.
Mark comes
best
the
best drummer of all time.
Oh, I'm not. I'm not playing.
I already know the answer.
Best drummer of all time.
Come on.
Immediate.
John Bonham.
Okay.
Stuart Copeland, the place.
Keithman.
Okay. I would probably say, who is that kid from Blink-182? Because he was...
Oh, my
he
God.
He never really...
No, not,
but he
now,
was good.
Sarah, not now, Sarah. Not now. Anyway,
the
answer is John Bonham. No.
He was really good. I didn't like the band.
I'm a close
really
second.
Good.
Stuart Copeland, the place.
The correct
never
answer was John
me,
Bonham.
Ever.
Travis Barker. That's who you're talking about.
He never
about.
Lost beat.
I,
my
I,
thing is,
going,
I'm like, okay, wait,
know,
drummer
Jared,
or percussionist?
Fuck.
Because there was a minute
you
when
me,
I
answered.
Wanted
you.
To just play wash tub.
You want to play some wash tub?
Okay.
I want to play
come on,
tub bass and washboard for the rest of my life.
John Bonham. Probably the best, but my favorite of all time is Levon Helm from the band. Levon Helm,
yeah.
By far the best.
Fat Pocket.
Have you ever
Fat
watched
pocket.
the He has a documentary about his last days.
Yeah, I'm
it's
singers. I don't really
amazing.
Get
amazing. It's on Netflix. I highly recommend
that out.
It. It's about
good
2 hours.
Good singer ain't nothing with
it's
a good
kind of
band
behind it.
It's depressing
at times, but
sure.
It's...
Sure. Someone that'll keep a beat.
Do you like...
Everyone's pretty good in the
band.
He just kept it in the pocket, but it gave it some. It gave what the song needed, and it's hard to find a drummer. It's hard to find drummers that want to just do what's necessary.
Yeah, they want to fucking make themselves prominent.
Yeah, they want to have their little.
They don't play for the song. They
I love drummers. I love drummers, and I would love to have a drummer in our band, but it's just really hard to find.
I would say locally, the guy that does the drums for Dry River Yacht Club,
Henry.
Henry's fucking amazing.
He's been in so many local bands. He just plays drums for everyone. He's amazing, though.
He looks shady to me.
No, he's a total sweetheart. He's a total sweetheart.
The thing is,
you can actually, like, he puts on his own show. Behind the drums.
Something going on.
You can hear this.
Something going on with that.
A little shout out.
Can you hear my hand?
No, no one can hear your hand.
Okay, well then, good. You're not upsetting anyone.
As songwriters, though, who's your favorite songwriter?
At the moment, Jason Isbell used to be in Driver Jakob. He used to be in
Drive-By Truckers.
Jason Isbell just put out a record called Southeastern that I think that pales in comparison. I mean, it's one of the most amazing records that I've ever heard in a really long time. Back to forth. I've listened to it 10 times, and I want to hear it again. Yeah. Jason Isbell, Southeastern.
Very
I'm sure
good.
You've heard that.
Oh, yeah.
It's fucking amazing.
It's his best yet, and he sobered up. He completely went sober and ended up writing one of the best records of the year.
And his wife is his...
Amanda Shire.
That's beautiful.
Amanda Shire. She plays...
Yeah,
I have to
really
say, though, it's really great when an artist gets sober and their music still is good. Because
he was in the hardcore shit. So.
But there's times when, like, people get sober and you're like, oh, this sucks. Get on drugs again.
Like, they get married
I feel bad for them when that happens.
He found love.
Oh,
too,
shit, you're only good on drugs.
That helps a lot. That helps, for sure.
But you had an answer to my question.
What was the question?
Favorite
was
songwriter.
Clear. It's Tom Petty.
Yeah?
Yep.
Tom Petty.
All
right.
He's
to me, is like, that guy can work three chords.
It's one of the best, for sure.
Beethoven orchestra monstrosity, and we didn't even see it coming.
Favorite.
Chris Knight is another favorite of ours. Is Chris, I'm not trying to bogart his.
No.
One of the conversations that we've had when I was bartending at the Crescent Ballroom and he came in and I served him, I got him fucked up. We bonded over Chris Knight one night.
Yes, we did.
Because no one knows about Chris Knight, and I mentioned it to you, and you were like, I know Chris Knight. I'm like, I like you immediately. I don't give a fuck who you are. I didn't even know you were in a band at the time. I was like, I mentioned Chris Knight because we were talking about songwriters.
Yep, yep.
No one knows about this guy, and he's the most underrated, I think.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
There's a ton out there that don't get enough credit, probably.
Well, okay, Tom Petty's way better than whoever you're talking about.
Tom Petty, I would lick his
come
ass.
On.
He's, yeah.
I could write a tune out of two chords. You know my favorite chord progression? G. We talked about this.
G to what, though?
Read my warning,
one chord
children.
Isn't a progression.
Wait,
yeah,
that's
not
a progression. What a progression
that is. That is
G
a
whiz.
Chord.
That is a constant.
Is it? Take a sip.
G, that's a good chord.
Oh, funny.
Oh, golly, G.
G. Oh, G, golly whiz.
Although I do use G a lot.
I know. It's like, sure.
How could you not use G ever?
Representing G.
I mean.
And you can go up to Capo 3 and it's all of a sudden it's a. Whatever it is in Capo 3.
What is it?
That's the 101.
And the 202?
I stopped after Capo 2. I realized after Capo 2 and the G position, that's A, so. And then after
three
that.
3 or 5.
Capo 11.
3 or 5 is where I leave my Capo at.
Yeah, 3 to 5.
Ooh.
And I'm super novice with
three,
this shit, too. Like,
four,
I.
Well, I am too. I don't know what key I'm in.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm like, it sounds good to me.
Yeah, exactly.
And then I drink more whiskey, and it sounds even better.
Even better.
Which I guess that might be why
you
feel guilty about going back on your I'm not drinking.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. He has to. He's
I'll
hearing.
Pass,
he's.
Sure.
It's like earphones. And he's hearing three conversations at once.
It's like, oh,
all
he's
the time.
Pushing the mic back between him and
how
I.
Do,
and I feel really
how do, is he on drugs?
No, Steve's just numb to everything right now.
You should write a song.
Aaron,
hey Steve,
will you marry
me? Oh, there he is. Hi.
Will you marry me? I said it. I just asked.
Does everything sounding okay?
That's the question. I
no.
Out of nowhere.
Sorry, Steve. I mean, Mark.
Oh!
He's probably like, these people.
God, you don't even know what
I'm
saying. Hey, I got. I'm
trying to apologize to my brother.
Let's turn it around.
I don't know.
How about a question for the girls?
Question
for
you
to
interview us?
I want a question for the girls. I think you're both adorable.
Oh, we know.
They know. That's why.
They know that they're adorable.
Duh.
What kind of. Guys want to know what kind of. guys do you girls love?
Womp womp.
Oh, is that a boring question? Is that a boring? I mean, what excites you?
So, actually, unfortunately, the only consistent thing I have with guys that I have actually dated, and I was attempting to make this a resolution to myself, not a New Year's resolution, but just a resolution in general. I have a habit of only dating musicians. And I
holy shit! It's like
there, everybody at a table here.
Right here. Girl,
and I need to not do that.
In my fucking goddamn
life. I need to not do that.
Will you fucking marry me?
Sit
you
down, Mark.
You fucking bitch.
Sit down, Mark.
Boo you!
That was the most romantic proposal I've ever heard.
How about you,
yeah.
Sir?
Mark Norman, let's get out of here.
You like quantum
fuck you.
Well, right? That was I mentioned this earlier. I was
so
like,
he has to be
we were
smart.
Talking about it, and I was like, the last time that I made out with someone, we were in the middle of talking about quantum physics.
What?
Would you think about making out with someone that has you having a conversation about the chord structure of a Led Zeppelin record?
It depends. Okay, and here's the thing. Like, yeah, Aaron, saying. Not your girlfriend. Here's the thing. Aaron
has
definitely dated a lot more musicians than I have. I've gone through, like, the artists, the musicians, the serious types, blah, blah, blah. I have horrible taste in men, and they all end up
being
total assholes. So I'm not, I know, and I'm self-aware enough to know, I probably am not the best person.
Shame on you!
I like,
when you
I like smart. Like,
oh, I love that bass and snare on 2 and 4.
No, because here's
let's
the thing.
Let's ask the guys what kind of guys they go for.
If you're a musician, but you can talk about other subjects.
Let's turn the tables around.
Totally, but yeah, we have four guys. Let's talk about what type of girls.
So last time
what
I was hanging out, it was about Immanuel Kant for like 3 hours. So your physics, I'll do philosophy, but...
No, just smart. Philosophy.
Fuck you!
Physics, intelligence, yeah.
More often than not, you just meet people that shug a lot.
There's a lot of posturing.
That's
glass
house.
It just costs
you want to know what the base of it is? I will tell you in a very short period of time.
What?
It's electricity between two people. That's all that
static.
Fucking matters.
What?
Doesn't matter if you like music or I like music. It's when you get with that person and there is you're discounting my
love to laundry.
You're discounting my
of course.
What I'm saying is if there's not electricity between the two people, might as well just go back off.
Fuck you.
Right? Am I right?
Mm,
am I right?
Girl.
How does chemistry work?
Okay.
That's what she said.
So that's all I have.
Well, and that's
you know,
the thing. That's the highest denominator.
I think
is
I agree.
Music.
Wait, Casey, I have a question for you, Casey. So you're talking about
what kind of sound stuff?
Sexual electricity. Is it
nice? Nice.
Is it all of the above?
It is like
sexual electricity will only get you good sex.
Yep.
Mental electricity will only get you good.
There's been a lot of talk about dicks.
But with the power,
everything is you can have great sex,
yeah,
good conversation,
yeah,
and you want to be around that person and
say hello to my
little
friend.
You want to think about that person.
See, okay, I'm totally
because that'd be perfect for Mark. Apparently, he has about dicks.
It doesn't matter about how that.
Who doesn't?
But okay, Casey, for you.
It's nothing about... That's what you're telling me. It's on the goddamn clock.
I feel like my business card
depends on the person.
It's just
Derek
personality.
Cooper.
Not, fetus.
Not personality, necessarily.
I mean, I can't even laugh anymore. That's
talking to that person, when you're around that person...
That's probably the worst.
It's how the person looks at you.
I think you want to say something.
I'm
going
to
tell
you. I honestly feel sorry for those.
No, we're on it. Everything that you say has to be said is on microphone.
Do we edit this at all later?
You guys, there's
like
no 17
court
conversations.
Editing. Everyone
Casey's
as far as staring at us right now because
no,
we're screwed
on
in.
Air, my
or at least one of us.
What
are
we
going to do with that stick?
Can we talk
about
Mark's cause for his...
Yes.
He's got a fundraiser for his micro penis. Right?
Micro penis? You say micro penis?
Yeah,
you
said
a small penis.
Our sound
I'm sorry.
Says
about
that.
That
Mark has a micro penis.
I have a black
funny,
penis,
man.
Penis, so
it's not even funny.
It's like,
but
Jesus Christ, I'm getting
already
crushed.
Looked at it. Nothing.
Jesus
that's
Christ.
That's Mark's penis envy of Casey's, which apparently is.
Oh, it's huge.
Sorry.
You know,
Mark wouldn't know if it did or not.
God,
you wouldn't know.
My dick's on fire.
Dude, I have references.
It's like all...
He's got a small dick. Like, you did, assholes.
Jesus Christ.
Not dicks and assholes.
They're actually a perfect
dicks
pair.
And assholes are
humiliated you. Oh my God.
Mark is already upset about dicks that are bigger dicks than him.
Well, now I just want to fuck the shit out of you so I can prove
it.
Oh! Oh!
Oh! Get back, Mark. She's mine. And I will fucking battle you
for
her.
Wait a minute.
I will battle you for her.
That was a knee-jerk reaction. That was a knee-jerk reaction.
Wow.
Jesus.
Yes,
I'm sorry.
But finally, I'm
sorry.
On the marriage list.
Yeah, there's a lot of people in line to marry.
I asked Aaron to be my...
I'm sorry.
By the way,
sorry.
Tyler's mom was here tonight.
Tyler's mom!
Oh, my mom. My mom's playing for us. We're saying hi, Mom.
Hey, Tyler, does your mom want to be on the radio?
Probably not.
Probably not.
How do you edit this? There's like 17 fucking conversations going on at the same time.
We average like 700 listeners a week because
no
we just wish they were our drunk friends,
yeah.
too.
I wish I was our drunk friend.
Shout out to everybody that tuned in.
I got a question. I'll put a little money on the table. I'll go get us a pitcher of beer.
You talk about me? Yeah.
I was trying to go around the table, but it keeps stopping at Casey.
Got my little money.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You have some energy. You don't want to know. You don't want to know.
You scratch my
dick,
Bill.
You got it.
Come on.
I think the world wants to know, Bill.
My little baby money. Yeah.
Let's go around the table again.
We all need a dollar. Put a dollar down. I'm going to go get us a pitcher.
Mark has my dollar.
Mark's at the point where he's just making noises.
You have some money for him?
Oh,
a lot of money floating around.
Well, because the boys made some hot bills tonight. Local artists, get
hey,
in
ladies.
On the Sunday service at the Timeout Lounge.
And a piece of matinee
for
day
drinkers.
Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you while you were doing this.
I thought we were doing it in sync.
Shame on you!
Timeout Lounge, Sunday service.
An
acoustic
matinee
for
day
drinkers.
That was pretty good.
That was
nice.
Good.
And keep tuning in to the Underground Railroad. We love you guys. 4-8 Radio Network.
Same
check out
seat.
Chili Bees.
Yes.
Flavor
Station. Cold Brew Coffee Cart Mobile will come to you. You come back. You don't have to come to us.
Right. And then
hit up. Crescent on Tuesday for Mr. Mudd and Mr. Gold.
Yep.
And hit up Mark Norman for everything and anything.
Hit up Mark Norman's Facebook for some really great pictures.
That's what I need. Tag me.
Hit up Mark Norman's Facebook for some epic pictures of Aaron and Corky.
And all your wingman needs.
And thank you, Derek, for sitting in.
Laughing a lot and talking over people.
All right. That's pretty
and good night.
Let's give it up to the lovely ladies.
Yeah.
Are we done? We're done?
Yay!
The lovely ladies.
From a song when I'm home.
see you once again. When I'm home, when I'm home, good to see you once again.
Production of the 4i Radio Network. For more great shows, check out www.4iradio.com.
Fuck you!